like to see Mather get thrown out of the game by Vernon.
Yeah, there you go.
Or get a couple flags on him. 5 foot 4 inch Mather going off. Thank you.
Hey, beef fans. Even though the game is almost over, there's still plenty of fun to be had at Therapy Bar and Grill, the official after-game party location of your Omaha Beef. Be sure to join the players, coaches, rump roasters, and even the prime dancers at Therapy Bar and Grill and catch up on all of the post-game excitement. We're less than 3 miles away at 5059 South 108th Street. We'll see you there, and go Beef.
Is your sink a little slow? Call American Rooter, the Sweet Plumbers. Now offering a $93 or a free drain clearing special. Locally owned and operated, we pride ourselves on quality, friendly service. We diagnose the entire plumbing system and advise you on the best, most cost-efficient options. American Rooter Plumbing, the Sweet Plumbers.
Every day brings a new opportunity to shine, to look at things with a fresh perspective, to take your amazing self and feel a shade more fearless and more comfortable in your own skin. Because when you look and feel good, your outlook on most everything changes for the better. Right now at Palm Beach Tan, get sunbed or spray tanning for only $14.95 a month. Make PBT and Australian Gold lotions a part of your beauty routine. Palm Beach Tan, a better shade of you.
What if it looked the way it actually felt? What if you could see how much it really hurts? And all the ways it changes your life and follows you wherever you go. Get a ride. A DUI costs more than you think.
Back at the Firewire Bar and Grill at the Comfort Inn and Suites 70th and Grover, live every Monday night.
That's right, beef fans. It's the Coach's Show, Monday nights at Firewater Bar and Grill from 6 to 7, where you can mingle with the players and prime dancers, win awesome prizes, and hear the latest from Coach himself. What do you think about that, Coach?
Well, I really don't have much to say about it.
Well, I'll make a good talk show.
We'll see you there. Go Beef.
You may not think of yourself as an athlete, but you do athletic feats. The Joint Chiropractic can help ease your pain and keep you on the active list. The Joint Chiropractic. Visit today and get your first consultation, exam, and adjustment for just $29.
Being entrusted with over 1,000 families' moves, 10 personal moves, and numerous investment properties has helped shape us into who we are. We are Lisa and Dennis Ritter of RE/MAX Results.
For decades, we have used our experiences to get better every day because we know that making a move is a big deal.
We truly know the stress of it. And it's helped shape us into who we are and how we serve our clients. And now we've won over 10 Best of Omaha awards. And we've earned the opportunity to serve hundreds of families and their real estate needs.
We can accomplish this because we have a team of industry experts that are the best in the business.
We have a professional photographer that's fabulous, a phenomenal social media expert, and an admin staff that absolutely rocks. We founded RE/MAX Results, and we named it that because really that's what it's all about. If you don't have results, you have nothing. When you hire us, you can not only count on the results, but you can count on feeling cared for during the process.
There are thousands of choices out there for real estate agents to hire, but many of them are doing it as a side job or just treating it as a transaction that needs to be closed. You deserve better.
When you work with us, You can count on great service that comes from the heart, exceptional communication, and smart financial advice that comes from learning about your goals and then making your real estate dreams a reality. Dennis and I are here to support you through your journey. Let us know how we can serve you.
Another beautiful night for indoor football. I'm Todd Walkenhorse. Kirk Heyer will join me shortly.
And tonight is a special presentation of the Boomer Sports Network.
Actually, I had you off. If you're just talking to me, sorry.
Special presentation of the Boomer Sports Network.
Ring your bell, stomp your feet. Everybody get ready for the Omaha Beef.
Jackson has time, looks at the end zone, has a man, it is caught! Wow. It's a touchdown! It's a diving catch for Tyler Jones! He's going downfield, he has a man, but it's short! It's intercepted!
You can't throw a pass to a fat guy.
Jones to 10 to 15. He's got room.
Wow.
25, 20, kicker. 15, 10, 5. Coast to coast.
But everybody knows what we come to see. And then
the snap. Placement's down. The kick is blocked.
Oh my God.
It's blocked. It's out of play.
Ring your bell. Stomp your feet. Everybody get ready for the Omaha Beef.
And it took 22 years of aging, but the Beef are now graded champions.
Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football is brought to you on the Boomer Sports Network by Amanda Spencer State Farm, All American Insurance, The Amazing Pizza Machine, Anybody Supplements, B. Douglas Construction, Beyond Golf, Bright Eyes, Bright Minds, Carp's Exteriors, Complete Fitness, Crown Property Management, DBS, Dean Snyder Construction, DG3 Construction, El Caribe, Eternal Tattoo, Evans Custom Apparel, Fazoli's, GBR, Guardian Windows, Home Matters Construction, Horsepower Realty, Hyde Slides, IAMS, Jerseys, JT Auto Body, Kelly Engineering, Last Time Exteriors, Lifestyles, Midwest Poured Walls, Midwest Quality Insulation, Midwest Title Company, Mike Jansen Custom Decks, the Nebraska Apartment Association, OCB Plumbing, OK Omaha Real Estate, Quality Fence, R Mechanical, See the Trainer, South O Roofing, T's Auto and Truck Sales, TO5 Bollywood, The Bullet Hole, The Garage Company, The Pit Barbecue Lounge, Titanium, Tracy's Collision Center, Treat Electric, Universal Bank and Trust, and Universal Trucks.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Liberty First Arena in Ralston, where it's another beautiful night for indoor football. I'm Todd Walkenhorse. Kirk Heyer will join me shortly. And tonight, the Omaha Beef return to the field to begin their quest for a third straight appearance in the CIF Championship game. Coming off a 7-3 season, the Beef hope to get off to a fast start and maybe finally secure home field for that elusive championship game. But there is a lot of work to do before we get to that point, and a lot of things have changed since the last time this team took the field. Head coach Marvin Jones has moved on. He took the head coaching job with expansion Tulsa Oilers of the IFL. Omaha then hired former head coach Pat Pimmel, who assembled a roster and then stepped down in January for personal reasons. Enter Rayshon Kaiser, head coach last season with the Massachusetts Pirates of the IFL. Kaiser started just over 6 weeks ago with the core roster already in place, a roster that saw a lot of turnover from the end of last season. Only five guys remain on the roster today from last season. Among them, veteran quarterback Andrew Jones is no longer with the team. He appeared in the last three Champions Bowls, two with Omaha, one with the Salina Liberty. Then this week, the Beef announced the signing of former University of Nebraska quarterback Tommy Armstrong. Armstrong, who has played indoor football the past three seasons with the Nebraska Danger and the Sioux Falls Storm. Looks to put an immediate spark into the Beef offense. And you can feel the excitement. For the first time since the Omaha Beef have moved to Ralston, they have officially sold out tonight's contest. It's a preseason contest with the Omaha Stockmen. A lot to start to figure out as we start rolling here tonight with the 2023 season. When we come back, we'll chat with the new head coach of the Omaha Beef.
The Heartland. Here, champions are revealed. What motivates us and sets us apart from those that have it and those that don't? It's the presence of mind knowing that we've been there before and we will be there again. It's the tenacity, the power, the passion to reach into your very soul, latch onto it, and rise above all obstacles to become legendary. Our preparation, our dedication, force us to endure. We may experience defeat, but we will not remain defeated. We are more than fans in the stands and players on the field. We are a family. This is our home, our team. This is the Slaughterhouse.
A business built on repeat customers. Guest line at 402-612-0791 or visit our website at souththeroofing.com. That's South Tho Roofing Company, the official roofing company of your Omaha Beef.
T's Auto and Trucks is the dealership you can trust when looking for the ultimate automobile buying experience. As a leading used car dealership, we will strive to be your premier choice for quality used cars in Omaha and the surrounding area. You can rest assured that T's Auto and Trucks will put you first and get your dream car at the price you deserve. Contact us and drive a better car today. Call us today, 402-733-4500, or visit us online at tsautoandtrucks.com.
The HVAC guy you called says your system is shot and needs to be replaced. Get a second opinion. Call Titanium HVAC and they'll tell you whether you actually do need a replacement or just a repair. Titanium HVAC, where honesty and quality come standard. TitaniumOmaha.com.
The Pit Barbecue Lounge on 72nd and Highway 370. The official barbecue of the Omaha Beef. Just ahead of the first preseason game, Omaha Beef 2023 season, joined by new Beef head coach Rayshon Kaiser. And coach, first off, welcome to Omaha. Second off, talk about, it's been a short time. It's not a traditional window that you got hired in. I've only been here about 6 or 7 weeks. Talk about the challenge of getting ready to kick off here tonight.
Well, main thing, like you said, it was a short turnaround. So I had a very short time to prepare. But last season prepared me to be the head coach. You know, coaching out of Mass last season. So, you know, just coming over here, trying to bring all that expertise that I learned over there. Challenges tonight, I'm not looking for too much. I just want the guys to come and compete, you know, play some good football. And we've been practicing for the last 2 weeks, so they ready to go. I know I'm ready to see them play, ready to see what type of product we're going to put on the field.
Kind of a unique situation here. Usually when jobs open up, it's a lot of times because the team hasn't had a lot of success. Not necessarily the case here. A team that's gone to a championship game 2 years in a row, but it's a whole different team now, personnel-wise. So talk about what you did last year with Massachusetts and the IFL, with the Pirates. Talk about what you did specifically as a coach and what kind of culture you're looking for with this Omaha Beef team.
Just looking for good character guys, and I feel like we have those guys on and off the field. I don't want to be babysitting.
For this evening's honorary group of the night, I have the pleasure of nominating and recognizing Humble and Kind, which is based right here in Sarpy County and is committed to helping others in need. An organization that focuses on children's needs, providing hats, coats, gloves, socks, and other basic necessities, but also helps and assists others navigating the job application process, assistance with food, teen mom, care, language, learning, just to name a few. Humble and Kind is a group of volunteers that want to be responsive to God's call to humbly serve and kindly care wherever we are all led. Thank you, Humble and Kind, for making a difference in our community.
I really set goals. I just want them to, you know, do their assignments, do they 1A on the defense and make plays when it's there. When you got the opportunity to make the play, make the play. That's what I'm looking for tonight. And like I say, just see who step up. You know, that's the biggest thing.
Offensive side of the ball, a little bit of news this week. You had a quarterback change. Was able to sign former Husker Tommy Armstrong. Fans are going to get to see him tonight, and looks like probably get a chance to see him the rest of the season here. Talk about what he brings to the team. A lot of fans don't know, casually. This is a player that comes in with indoor experience and really a skill set that is really good for the indoor game.
Yeah, I love Tommy. He came in right away, professional, all around, leading the troops on and off the field. I feel like he ran Coach Tatum offense when he played out in Sioux Falls, so he's very familiar with the offense we were trying to run here. And like I said, we're looking for Tommy to do great things this year. Like he came in and hit full stride right away, and the offense just clicked to another cylinder when he came in. So I'm looking forward to tonight and seeing what he can bring to that offense.
Tell us one or two players through the first 2 weeks of camp that surprised you we should watch for tonight.
Devonair, he's a receiver. Number five tonight. He'll be wearing number five tonight. He's definitely stood out to us. Reggie Patrick, no stranger. He's been here the last several years. But I like his leadership on the offensive line. Very good player. Let me see if there's anybody else that jump out on offense. We all know about Tommy Armstrong, of course. Natural leader. And we just got a good group. We got a solid offensive line. We got some good receivers that should be competing tonight. I'm just looking forward to see which ones step up tonight and make some plays.
At least put you on the spot for one question. What is something you think the team needs to work on tonight or something you'd like to see cleaned up a little bit in game action?
Just communicating and just making sure we're on the same page. I feel like sometimes some practices of offense might have looked a little sloppy. Some practices of defense might look a little sloppy. So just trying to come together and just clean up all the miscommunication we've been having throughout the week and putting together a complete game. And let's go out here and have fun.
That's head coach of the Beef, Rayshon Kaiser. Again, welcome to Omaha. Good luck tonight.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Universal Trucks is conveniently located in Omaha, just off I-80 at exit 440. At Universal Trucks, they have a great selection of heavy and medium-duty trucks and trailers. If you're interested in their amazing selection, visit online for more information at universaltrks.com or call 402-891-2652.
Hottest investments around right now are in real estate, but once you purchase the rental property, you need to make sure you manage it right. Crown Property Management, they will help. Many property management companies are not proactive when managing your rentals. The end result? More repairs, more fees, more cost to you because of their lack of management. These aren't property managers, they're rent collectors. Crown Property Management will make sure that your dream investments don't become your nightmares. End result, more money in your pocket. Contact us today, crownmanagementomaha.com.
At Union Bank, people don't have your money. Your money has people. First Home people, investment people, people people, people who answer the phone and your chats, dream car people, dream retirement people, driving your dream car in your dream retirement people, small business people, credit card people, and all the other people you need. At Union Bank, our people help you do more than you dreamed possible. So stop in and say hello. We can't wait to see you. Union Bank and Trust, member FDIC.
Mike Jansen Custom Decks is one of Omaha's premier deck builders, family owned and operated since 1988. They design and build custom decks in wood, composite, or PVC in all sizes, shapes, and designs. Whether you're adding a deck to your home or replacing or enlarging an existing deck, Mike Jansen Custom Decks can help you plan and design a new deck to suit your individual needs and the custom extras you may have in mind. Visit jansendecks.com to learn more. If you're ready for a new, beautiful, customized deck, call Mike Jansen Custom Decks at 402-896-6897.
Lifestyles, Orthotics, and Prosthetics have knowledgeable and experienced staff that have been working with orthopedic surgeons, therapists, and patients for over 25 years. We're a local practitioner-owned O&P facility that puts the needs of our patients first. Find the most up-to-date and state-of-the-art technologies for both upper and lower prosthetics at Lifestyles. We provide patients with custom orthotics and shoe inserts created and modified specifically for you in our clinic workshop. Count on the professionals at Lifestyle Orthotics and Prosthetics to get you moving again. Visit lifestylesop.com and see their customizable plans that fit your needs. Ready for a change today? Perfect. Give them a call now at 402-393-2354.
Midwest Quality Insulation treats your home as they would theirs. Midwest Quality Insulation works directly with homeowners, builders, and contractors throughout the Omaha metro area. Go to MidwestQualityInsulation.online and take a look at their vast insulation services, including spray foam, open-closed cell spray foam, fiberglass bats, and many more. Ready to insulate now? Give Midwest Quality Insulation a call at 402-871-9832.
The Pit Barbecue Lounge on 72nd and Highway 370, the official barbecue of the Omaha Beef.
Well, it's almost that time. Here we are again. Todd Walkenhorst, there is Kirk Heyer, and we are ready to start the indoor football season. It's March, it's spring right around the corner, and you know, you could kind of feel a little bit of the excitement here tonight. We talked about it in the open. It's a new team. There's a lot of new things going on out there. What are you excited to see here tonight?
Well, I'm excited to see. This is a sellout tonight.
And you can see there's a lot of people here.
Wonderful, wonderful. And sponsors, my goodness, I see so many banners on the field, around the field, and everything. So very, very good support from the business community here. So very, very happy. Here again. Five people from last year's team are here now. So totally new look. You know, the addition, obviously, of Tommy Armstrong makes a big, big deal for the offense of the Omaha Beef.
That's the one that got some attention this week, and it figures to be a good boost to the Omaha offense. Of course, you had Andrew Jackson, and he was a veteran quarterback. You can't take anything away from him. He went to three straight Champions Bowls. He won one of them, two with Omaha, one with Salina. The only knock, if you will, on him was he was a great passer, was not really a dual threat, which is tough in this game, but he made up for it with his arm. That's something that's going to be different bringing in a Tommy Armstrong here in Omaha.
Well, that was true, and that's Andrew had a lot with Rashawn Pargo and some of the people he was very, very familiar with. This is something new. Tommy's coming in. I'm obviously, he's got some good athletes and receivers, and we will see those things as they come through, but the dual threat of throwing and being able to run the ball is tremendous in the indoor game.
You talked about the mass turnover on the roster, and the real reason for that is, just like you're alluding to, we saw a lot of veterans on the Omaha roster for the last couple of years, and, you know, I don't want to say it was a youth movement or anything, but it kind of played out. Change of coaches, change of regimes, and that's where we saw a lot of the turnover personnel.
And we look at Trey Dudley-Giles Chris, CP3, my mind, but I mean two big difference makers over the past few years, so very glad to have them here. We've got offensive line, huge, huge people, you know, and we got, you know, Fluker came in, who played at Salina last year, joined us because he got a job here in Omaha. And as I said, we're going through Jordan Barton, wide receiver, came back from last year. And Reggie Patrick, who Coach mentioned being a leader in this preseason camp.
Let's set the stage tonight. Preseason contest as Omaha tunes up for the regular season opener. That will be Friday night here at the Slaughterhouse as they host Billings at 7:05. That's Friday at 7:05. We'll talk about that later, but the task tonight for the Beef, they carry 35 players in the preseason. They need to cut down to 25 by Wednesday. They'll do that in the next day or two. There's some guys that are fighting for their jobs, obviously trying to make that last impression on the coaching staff. They'll do that tonight. against the Omaha Stockmen. It's a in-town, semi-pro, outdoor, 11-man team. We know how these games are going to go. You have a professional team against a semi-pro team. They do have good athletes. This is a team that's won back-to-back championships in their outdoor league. But there's still going to be a little bit of a gap. But they have some players that would be fun to watch, too.
Well, it is true. The thing is that we've seen the past few years in the exhibition games, things get a little bit chippy. I don't know if somebody's trying to prove something or whatever, but that was the only drawback of something like this.
Rayshon Kaiser, we mentioned, new head coach for Omaha, for the Omaha Stockmen. Familiar face, Andrew Mathers. He coached with us way back, back in the Civic Auditorium days at the end of the Civic days. Kind of left the indoor game. He's got real jobs like most of us. You know, he's a principal at some school or whatever.
Yeah.
And has spent the last, I believe it's 7 or 8 years now, with the Omaha Stockmen organization from the inception. They've grown into what they are now. He's actually owner with his brother. And you figure hopefully that keeps it from getting too terribly chippy here tonight. That's enough talking. It's time to play some football and to get us started. New kicker, only kicker on the roster for Omaha, but it's a familiar name, Brandon Stewart. I mean, if you're a diehard Beef fan, it's a familiar name.
Remember.
It's a player that has been around, including in Omaha. We last saw him last season down in Topeka with the Tropics, but the key is, he was my age. He's pretty close to my age. He's 47 years old, I believe, as he kicks off here tonight out of Kent State. We'll see. He may not have quite the leg, but we'll see. We're going to talk about kickers. It's a little different in this league this season and what they want to do with him, but he is going to get us started as he marches it off, the left-footed kicker here tonight. Omaha in their home black jerseys, orange pants, Stockmen white trimmed in red. We are ready for football action here on the Boomer Sports Network. Squib kick is going to be fielded at the 6-yard line, back on his feet. That's Al German, who gets it out to the 9-yard line. Excuse me. That was Vic Sweeney. Brings it out to the 9-yard line on the return. So Stockmen will start at their own 9-yard line. And, you know, I was kind of talking with their coach before the game. We always see these preseason games, right? The defensive line, they're going to match up better than the offensive line, right? And they want to impress them, so they bring the pressure right away, right? See if they throw a couple screens or something, try to affect that timing, because you got to get your legs and your timing early to understand what you're playing against. We'll see what the Stockmen do as we are getting started. Omaha Stockmen, Omaha Beef, the Stockmen are moving left or right on your Boomer radio dial. Glad you're joining us here as we kick off the 2023 season. Right guard, waiving eligible. That's one good thing. We sometimes don't even see these rules being known by these exhibition teams that come in. But they do know that they have an eligible receiver. They fake the handoff, a little dive out, and they do a little trickery as it's thrown downfield by the halfback. They talked about that they wanted to open the play with that. They didn't know if they could. But the upside on that is you're going to make that defense think a little bit. There's some stuff going on behind there. They came to play ball.
Little bit of a shot put action on that pass there.
Yeah, he said he had a couple guys who could throw the ball. I'm not sure he was one of them right there, as that ball was a little off target, but a little trickery makes it second down and 10 after the incomplete pass. The Stockmen opening drive of the game. They start at their own 8-yard line. Here's the rush. It's a keeper by the quarterback, bounces around. That's Shaka Taylor. Picks up 1 yard out to the 9-yard line. They'll give him the 10. It'll be third down and 8. Oh, now they'll back it back up a yard. We've seen worse starts, actually, Kirk.
Yes.
In these exhibition games. We've seen teams just, you know, drop that first ball and give up a touchdown or a turnover or whatnot. So it's a good start here for the Stockmen. Taylor puts the men in motion, the slots, good indoor formation. Wants to throw an ugly ball to nobody. It's incomplete, should have been intercepted. And that's that pass rush that they're going to have to make some adjustments that comes a lot faster in this game.
Well, and it was a poor snap, too, because he had to pick it up off of the floor. So
Be fourth down. If you're new to the indoor game, there is no punting. You could attempt a long field goal. It could be returned, but the Stockmen will keep their offense on the field on fourth down and nine, deep in their own territory, as the clock goes under 13 minutes of the opening quarter of play. Same formation for the Stockmen. Two wideouts on each side, two in the upper slots. Taylor will put the slots in motion. Good snap this time. Drop back. Oh. Has time. Better pass. And it's nearly intercepted. Good for Omaha that it wasn't, because this ball's going to come all the way back down to the 9-yard line, where the Beef are going to have first and goal. The interception, they would have lost about 30 yards unless they got a pretty good return on that, Kirk.
Yeah, and that ball just thrown up, just hoping nothing would happen.
You know, this is the first time that I've seen the Stockmen a few times over the last few years. This is the first time I've seen Taylor at that quarterback position. They've got a couple other guys, though, that have played in that position, including Al German. He is listed as a defensive back. He was quarterback for them 3 or 4 years ago. We've seen Jay Swenson take snaps as well. I'm not sure if he's suited up here. I have not seen his number. But first time, Omaha offense on the field. And it'll be first down and goal from the 10-yard line. Tommy Armstrong hands it off. And it's good for 4 yards to the 5-yard line. A nice easy play to acclimate the Husker quarterback to the Beef offense. You figure you're not going to see too much fancy tonight. Talking with the head coach Kaiser before the game, you know, you want to see clean plays. You know they're not going to do anything too extravagant, but you did want to see that offense running on all cylinders. Pistol formation for the Beef. Armstrong puts the men in motion. He hands off once again, actually keeps himself, and he's sacked. Can you believe that? The Omaha Stockmen come in and get a sack on Tommy Armstrong. That was Marlon Thomas, who came right up the middle. And I'll tell you what, there's going to be an offensive line coach who is not happy to see that play right there.
No.
So loss of a yard or two. They spot the ball at the 10-yard line. And what looked like an easy opportunity for Omaha on offense is now third down and goal from the 10-yard line. First possession of the 2023 preseason for the Beef. Armstrong puts the men in motion, draws back, has time, floats it. It's nearly picked off, but it's broken up by Michael Schiffer. Nice play on the ball. He read that all the way, came in, and Omaha will send the kicking unit out to see if they could get 3 points. What a big momentum win for the Stockmen.
Yeah, it was. I mean, he had to throw a check down. There was nothing downfield, nothing open at all.
So we will see Brandon Stewart attempt from 24 yards out. His numbers were not spectacular by any means in Topeka. There could be a lot of factors for that. We didn't watch a lot of Topeka game films. Nothing was too spectacular in Topeka in 2022. And it's going to be interesting to see as we have official timeout here.
I think they're talking about alignments.
Yeah, they're helping the rushers. They're helping the defense, or here on special teams, making sure. And they do that in the preseason with these teams that don't normally play the 8-man rules, got them all set up, trying to make sure they get good plays off. And they still, I think, they have one too many on the line.
Yeah.
As they have to square them up, and they're getting it all sorted out now. So, back to action. Omaha trying to get on the board. As Stewart will come in, this will be a 24-yard kick for the left-footed kicker out of Kent State. Snap is down, placement's up, and it
good.
Is good. Just inside that right upright, but there's
flag.
A flag on the play, and I think they got a piece of Stewart. They're claiming they tipped the ball. I thought the ball may have been tipped with the way that it came off, because it did not look like it flew through the air cleanly. The officials will discuss it before they make a call. They briefly eliminated instant replay reviews of the CIF during the offseason, but they brought it back, and they're going to wave off the flag. So there was contact. And the end result, the field goal is good from 24 yards out. Stewart puts the Beef on the board 3-0 with 10:04 remaining here in the first quarter. But let's talk about that. That's not quite what you would have expected. Starting from the 9-yard line, the Stockmen's got, I mean, still not going to make any imagination they're going to win this game, but I mean, they're going to go out and play a little bit and think, you know, we sacked Tommy Armstrong on one play, and we kept them out of the end zone.
Yeah, it was the first play, you know, good run, and then back, and then the sack of Tommy, and then to try to throw the ball, and it didn't work.
So. Vice versa, Omaha side, some concerns there very early on, don't want to panic yet, but we saw offensive line either missed assignment or just missed block, and we saw a couple of wide receivers not get open on a couple plays there.
Well, too, and here again for their defense, too, they're charged up a little bit. They want to make it happen. And
Beef 3, Stockmen nothing. 10:04 remaining here. Opening quarter of play. Stewart, after the 24-yard field goal attempt, will put it into play. He'll kick it off his left hash mark at the goal line. High end-over-end kick this time. He'll be fielded at the 3-yard line and brought out to the 5, the 10, looking for a lane. It closes up quick, bounces outside, though. It fights across the 15-yard line in another impressive effort by the Stockmen. That time, it was Tyler Levy on the return. Picks up a good 12 yards on the return. That was hard fought.
Yeah, good run. You know, we talked about things getting a little bit chippy.
It did get chippy already. And when you don't come in and, you know, play the script the way you expect it to play, it's a good way to stir some emotions up, and we're seeing that right now. So that's another thing. As we said, there's so much to see this year that's new. That was something Omaha, for the most part, did pretty good under Marvin Jones. They kept their cool. They kept their composure.
Yeah.
Veteran team again. We're just going to have to see new personalities, what the component makeup and style of this team is here in 2023. Stockmen's second possession, they trail 3-0. They're gonna stay out of their base formation. Taylor takes the ball, tries to get his first completion. It is off the mark and incomplete. Attended receiver was Vic Sweeney.
Trey
a little bit
Dudley
high
Giles.
And outside, Trey Dudley Giles on the coverage.
Yeah, between him and CP, they're with two of the better defensive backs in the league.
Running clock here in indoor football. If you're new to the game, for the most part, it will go nonstop as we go under 9 minutes here in the first quarter. Second down and 10 for the Stockmen. They'll stay in that same formation. Taylor will cross up the high motion in the backfield, takes a snap, turns the ball, and looks for his tight end in and out of his hands. That's Jay Swenson, according to the number. He's 6'1", 240. He's a little bigger than the last time I saw him out of Briar Cliff University. So incomplete pass, third down and 10. Stockmen trying to find a positive play here on offense. Then in motion, Taylor takes the ball, rushes outside. First completion.
Yes.
It's across the 20 out to the 22-yard line. That's Reed Chowell. He's good for 5 yards. It'll be fourth down, and they will go for it at the 22-yard line. They went for it at their own 9. You figure they're going to go for it at their own 22. We saw their kicker before the game. And Nathan Enriquez, and he's not a long foot. It's going to take a good field position to get him in the game. So fourth down for Omaha. Stockmen, can the Beef stop him? Here comes the rush. They bring everybody in. It's intercepted. Chris Perry off the left sideline. 10-5, touchdown CP3. And Perry is in the end zone, and the first defense, our first touchdown of the game, is scored by the defense
intercepts it and returns it 24 yards for the touchdown.
We saw that. Very good. You know, and a lot of things we missed last year when he was injured. I mean, he's a leader out there.
You knew they were going to throw on fourth down and five. They got a pretty good pass rush, and ball once again off the mark. Unfortunately, Chris Perry is right there, is able to jump up, bring it down, and take it all the way to the end zone as Omaha Beef score their first touchdown to take a 9-0 lead. Now, there are some new conversion rules of the CIF this year, the CIF bonus round. They're going to go for the traditional extra point. There's a 2, 3, and 4-point option. We'll talk about that later in the game, as we probably won't see much of that here tonight. Stewart comes in looking for the extra point, and he went wide to the left. Stewart was shaky, as we mentioned, in Topeka on extra points. Very, very low percentage. Again, lots of factors that go into that, but they're going to want to see him make some of those extra points, especially with the new conversion rules. We will talk about those a little bit later. We have a timeout on the field with 6:51 remaining here in the opening quarter of play. The Beef, 9, Stockmen, nothing. You're listening to Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football here on the Boomer Sports Network.
At All American Insurance, our local independent agency is committed to providing a personalized consultation to ensure that we're protecting those things that matter most to our clients. We are licensed and experienced professionals, partnering with industry insurance companies and offering a broad range of insurance products. Visit aaiomaha.com to see everything we have to offer for insurance, or give us a call at 402-932-1500 to get a quote.
State Farm Insurance agent Amanda Spencer is not only a proud sponsor of the Omaha Beef, but also the proud sponsor of the honorary Family of the Game at all Omaha Beef home games that recognizes those who give back to our community. Amanda and her staff serve the entire states of Nebraska and Iowa, so call her today at 402-346-5553 for a free quote on your car, home, renter's, life, or business insurance needs. You can also visit her website at aspencerinsurance.com. State Farm agent Amanda Spencer, proud sponsor of your Omaha Beef.
The Amazing Pizza Machine, voted Omaha's best family entertainment center and best place for birthday parties. The Amazing Pizza Machine is the perfect destination for any celebration, from family gatherings, post-proms, corporate events, and birthday parties. With laser tag, thrill rides, go-karts, bowling, arcade games, and an unlimited buffet, the food and fun at Amazing Pizza Machine never ends. That's the Amazing
Your
Pizza
Omaha Beef
Machine
are proud to announce tonight's Omaha sponsors, including Moose Roofing, Don Muckey American Family Insurance, Nebraska Department of Transportation, 72 Table and Tap, and Cabinet Factory Outlet. Your Omaha Beef want to give a big shout out to tonight's sponsors, including Charlie's on the Lake, Ralston Kino, First Impressions, Palm Beach Tan, and Home Matters Construction. Thanks for being a part of the Omaha Beef.
Back at Ralston, 6:51 to go, opening quarter of play. Preseason action here for the Omaha Beef as they lead the Omaha Stockmen 9-0. Stewart to kick off for Omaha. Approaches the ball, low line drive kick, bounces and fielded at the 5, out to the 10, the 15. Nice move, but then stopped at the 17-yard line. Return of 12 yards. Tyler Levy once again on the return for the Stockmen, and they will start at their own 12-yard line, or 17-yard line. Kirk, preseason action here tonight, but three regular season games tonight opening up in the CIF. Six teams out of the 8 are opening regular season play tonight. We'll be keeping an eye on those games, as Omaha will start their regular season next week. We have Gillette at Southwest Kansas, Topeka at Salina, and Rapid City visiting Sioux City. So the Omaha Stockmen trying to find something positive on offense.
But Rapid City has had an exhibition game, have they not?
Rapid City played an exhibition game. Sioux City played an exhibition game last week.
Both those teams are in action. Billings did not play an exhibition game preseason, so they will come in for their first action as they kick off the regular season Friday night here at the Slaughterhouse. Pistol formation on first and 10 for the Stockmen. U wide motion, and we got a false start.
Yep.
Whoa, and a late hit on Omaha. No flag on that play. Javari Nichols, Southeast Louisiana, is lucky that he did not get flagged on
flag
that. He took
that
a free hit after a whistle and a flag that was thrown right in front of his face as that play was blown dead. They tried the loop high motion out of the backfield, a little different play formation that they've run so far. Again, not an outdoor team. The high motion and all that, this is new to them. They've just learned this in the last couple weeks. Tried to vary up the offense a little bit. They got called for the false start. Looks like they're going to try the same thing again. They'll bring two around behind the quarterback this time. Looks, tries to set up the screen. There it is. Good for a couple of yards on the near side. We talked about that in the pregame.
Starting again.
And now we got some pushing and shoving. And like you said, this happens in the preseason games. A couple of reasons. One, you get frustrated. Two, you haven't hit anybody, you know, all year. And three, sometimes the exhibition team, you know, there's no ramifications as far as the league goes for misconduct. No flags there. We'll have to keep an eye on how the officials monitor that situation going forward. It's second down and 13 yards is it's at the 13-yard line. They stack the near side. They put two in high motion. Taylor takes it, and a nice completion again out near the 19-yard line and finally brought down. That's a gain of 7 yards on the play. It's going to be third down and 7.
Something that I see where they kind of flooded the zone. They had two receivers.
Nice play, and at least set up the concept of a screen there. We talked to him about doing that. You know, that's really what you need to do, try to break that pass rush. You can see how aggressive Omaha is getting on defense. Trying to make some impressions here tonight as they fight for those 25 roster spots. Continuous resetting of the play clock. We're all for that here tonight as they put another 25 seconds on the play clock as we approach the 4-minute mark. They're going to stack this near side once again. We'll see if they run the same play, Kirk. Pistol formation. Taylor puts two into low high motion, and here comes the pass rush. Breaks past the first, but he can't get away. And he is sacked at the 14-yard line. That's a loss of 6 yards. And it's going to be third down and about 11. We're making fourth down 11 for the Stockmen. The Stockmen still trying to get their first down of the night. It looks like they're actually going to bring the kicking unit on the field to kick for the first time tonight. Nathan Enriquez out of Midland University is going to be kicking from his own 7-yard line. Technically, again, a field goal attempt. This would be 49 yards if he nailed it from here. He squares it up, puts his foot into it. It's going to be well short. Going to have to come up to field it. It's fielded at the 2. Out to the outside, the 10, the 15. Has a seam. Midfield 20 has the kicker. And the kicker prevents the touchdown. Draco Statham on the return for Omaha. He thought he had it. He was through the traffic. Found his lane, got deep into Stockmen territory, saw a couple white jerseys. One of them was the kicker, and the kicker of all people got enough on him to bring him down to the 6-yard line.
He kind of had to slow down a little bit for his blockers to catch up. And
so a return of 43 yards puts it first and goal from the 6-yard line for the Beef. Pistol formation, second time out tonight for Tommy Armstrong. He puts the men into high motion. They'll keep it on the ground once again. Hand off to the running back. Good for 3 yards down to the 3-yard line. And it'll be second down and goal. Jalen Singleton, North American University, on the carry. seen much of the offense so far tonight. The touchdown was scored on defense on a Chris Perry interception return for a touchdown. 9-0 Beef as we approach the 2-minute mark. Armstrong puts two men in motion on the right side, hands off once again to his running back, and he's into the end zone for a touchdown. Singleton with his first touchdown from 3 yards out, and Omaha leads 15-0.
Now a lot of finger pointing going on in the end zone again.
So we'll talk about it real quick here. We talked about some new rules this year. Of course, you can kick the extra point. There's a two-point conversion. They have added the option, Kirk. And we're going to be talking about this all season, I guarantee you. You can run a play from scrimmage from the 5-yard line, good for 3 points.
Right.
Or from the 10-yard line for 4 points. When they get to real action, we'll see what the teams elect to do. I know what I'd be doing. We'll talk more about that. Not good news for kickers, I'll tell you that.
No.
Which makes these preseason PAT attempts even more important here for these kickers, as Brandon Stewart missed his last extra point. We'll try again to put the Beef up by 16. We're under a minute to go. Low snap to get it down. The kick is up, and that one is good. 55 seconds remaining. First quarter of play. Omaha Beef 16. Omaha Stockmen nothing. Timeout on the field. We'll be right back. You're listening to Omaha Beef, professional indoor football all across the Boomer Sports Network.
Are you looking for ways to get focused in 2023? Whether it's to find the healthiest version of yourself or to get stronger, at Anybody Supplements, we want to help make 2023 your best year yet. Go to AnybodySupplementsOmaha.com and check out the one-of-a-kind selection of pre-workouts, weight management solutions, protein, and recovery. You can even stop by the store at 108th and Center. Call 513-466-4758. The amazing staff will get you on the right path to a healthy lifestyle.
B. Douglas Construction offers full-service construction and remodeling. If you dream it, B. Douglas Construction can and will build it. B. Douglas is an insured company providing construction services for both residential and commercial properties. Check out all of their amazing services. Visit their website, bdouglasconstruction.com, or give their great staff a call at 402-885-8505.
Better Bodies, powered by Complete Fitness, is the official health club and fitness center of the Omaha Beef, located at 4117 South 120th Street in Omaha. We are a family-owned business and have been serving the people of Omaha for 30-plus years. Every day, we are changing people's lives and making a positive impact on their health. We have the programming, facility, and staff to help you reach your goals. Come in and experience our friendly, motivational, and helpful atmosphere for yourself with no obligation. If you are like hundreds of your friends,
let's give a big shout-out to some of tonight's sponsors for your Omaha Beef, including Tom Manley Floors, Valpak of Omaha, Hot Works La Vista and Bellevue, American Rooter Plumbing, and Mata Auto Repair. Thanks for being a part of your Omaha Beef.
55 seconds to go here. First quarter of play, preseason game.
We'll be back to more action on the field in just a second. But first, let's take a moment to thank some great sponsors for your Omaha Beef, including Last Time Exteriors, Stocks and Bonds, Primerica, Valdez Painting, and Honeyman Rentals.
As a couple of runs on the ground get the Beef into the end zone for their first offensive touchdown, they're up by 16. Brandon Stewart will put it into play. Approaches the ball, booms it in the air, and it's a bounce into the corner of the end zone. It's going to be fielded. He's got to get it out. He does. Cuts back out to the 5 off of one blocker and down to the 7, and we're seeing some more bodies fly around as the return once again is by Tyler Levy. Five seconds to go, opening quarter. Omaha will open the 2023 regular season Friday night against Billings. Still some tickets left for that. Tickets have been going quick in the last week. Sold out here tonight. And look looking for more of the same as the season gets going. Some season tickets left for the regular season. Five-game package. Check with the Beef ticket office for more information. Should be last play of the first quarter. Whoa. It's a high snap into the end zone off the backboard. They'll fall on it, and he can't wrap it up. Omaha looks like they're on top of it.
Touchdown.
If he is, it's a touchdown, and we're waiting for the signal.
Oh.
And it is a touchdown for Omaha. Did not see who finally fell on it, but it was a bad snap. It went to the back dasher board, and Taylor could not wrap it up, and the defense fell on it for 6 points. Actually, got a new quarterback in there, it appears. Jay Swenson moved back. That was his first snap. He played quarterback for the Stockmen in previous seasons. As we mentioned, they've got some veteran players that have been with that team for most of the 7 or 8 year history of the franchise. Swenson is one of those. Here comes Stewart looking to make it second extra point in a row. The placement's down, the kick is up, and it is no good. He missed wide to the right. He's 1 for 3 on extra points here tonight. Reached the end of the first quarter of play. Beef out in front. It was ugly, but they're out in front 22-0. We'll come back quarter number two. You're listening to Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football on the Boomer Sports Network.
Beyond Golf, located at 12040 McDermott Plaza in La Vista, opened its doors in 2009 in an effort to bridge the long seasonal gap to Midwest golfers. In 2012, the first major addition was our kitchen, and we haven't looked back since. Beyond Golf features indoor golf on some of the world's most famous courses. Enjoy a round of golf in a laid-back atmosphere complete with a full bar, gourmet food menu, and big-screen TVs. Book your tee time online or drop in for one of our craft cocktails, craft beer on draft, or delicious food items. Visit our website at www.beyondgolf.com or by calling us at 402-916-4727.
Bright Minds Learning Center is the official daycare provider of the Omaha Beef. With flexible hours for both mornings and nights, they're here to help with your most precious gifts, your children. With directors and staff on hand to provide a clean, safe, and educational environment, plus being one of just a few daycares who provide transportation to and from school, it's no surprise that they have such amazing reviews and testimonials from their clients. Schedule an appointment or visit today by calling 402-934-5566 or visit their Facebook page, Bright Minds Learning Center, for more info. Again, that's Bright Minds Learning Center, the official daycare provider of the Omaha Beef.
The Bullet Hole is a veteran-owned and operated indoor shooting range. They offer firearm sales and gunsmithing services. Come join them on Mondays and Thursdays for their lead slinger gun drills, where you can perfect your firearm skills and build confidence in your ability to protect your loved ones. Visit them online at thebh.com.
Welcome back to the
This break in your Omaha
in
Beef action is brought to you
books.
By Drew Metzler, State
Farm
Insurance,
Kirk,
Auto Graphics,
like
Truck
Very
Now,
so.
Gershwin Mortgage, and Artisan Roofing. For more information on how you could become a great partner with
defense,
the Omaha Beef, call
402-346-BEEF.
They will
agree when they go back and they
Let's
look
give
at
another
video. And that was, again, that's what preseason's all about. You don't
More
have
action coming your way in just a moment.
Up,
but first, let's give another shout
deal.
Out to some great sponsors here with the Omaha Beef. Nebraska
least,
Family Chiropractic. Innovative Outdoors. J&S Renovation. Patera Landscaping. And Monarch Tires. Thanks again for being a part of the Omaha Beef.
Second string. Not that there's a lot of extra players.
It's time for another shout out for some awesome, amazing Omaha Beef partners. Including
Tommy
Nebraska Sneakers, Nexterior Construction,
and
Dirt Devil Detailing,
that,
Apple Roofing,
down, dude,
and Omaha Orthopedic
happen,
Clinic.
Because they've kind of went to that option a little bit. But then again, they...
Thanks to all our awesome fans here in support
very,
at the Slaughterhouse
smooth,
tonight.
Really.
Let's also give a big
now,
shout out to Danielson Incorporated,
Tommy
Hometown
Armstrong
Roofing,
joined the team,
Cyril Auto Body,
Tuesday,
Heartland Audio,
after
and Starkey Auto Care. Thanks for being a part of your Omaha Beef.
Training camps with practice Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Walkthrough on Friday. Not a lot of reps necessarily. He wasn't a quarterback camp though.
No.
Before he came up here,
yeah.
So he's been doing game activities. So it's not like he's out of shape or anything like that.
No.
He's been competing and working on those skills, just not in this particular offense. Although he's seen a lot of it because Mike Tatum, the offensive coordinator, was with him up in Sioux Falls the last two seasons. So we'll see how quarter number two goes for Omaha as Stewart kicks it off. It's hit at midfield, and the Stockmen will actually start in Beef side of the field for their best field position of the night, starting at the Beef 24-yard line. So we have not seen the Stockmen get a first down, move the ball, or done a whole lot effectively. They've made a quarterback switch. They're going to let Jay Swenson have a shot and see if they can find some success. Another thing to keep in mind, we talked about in the opener when we talked with Stockmen head coach Andrew Mather, their season doesn't even start until late April. I mean, they are 6 weeks out from even playing in a game, so it's a little different mindset, too. They were playing for the last couple of weeks, practicing, trying to get ready for this, but they are nowhere near mid-season form as they will be preparing for their season the end of next month. Swenson hands it off on first down, scooting around the backfield, nothing doing, loss on the play of 3 or 4 yards. Geronimo Ramirez, the running back, on the carry. Lost about 4 yards back on the Beef side of the 25. They spot at the 22-yard line. It'll be second down and 15. Kind of like it. Black Belt Movers, the sponsor of the chains, actually have the chain gang dressed as ninjas this year. It's marketing. One man, high motion for the Stockmen. Here comes the pass rush. And Sweeney, or Swenson, is spun around and tackled for a loss back at the 15-yard line. Another loss of 7. Be third down and 22 as Omaha seems to be getting that pass rush going. Again, different level of talent that they're going against, and that's something we always see in the preseason. The defensive lines love to go to town on the lesser offensive lines that they'll play. It'll be tougher competition once league season begins next Friday. Two men, high motion out of the slots for the Stockmen. Swenson wants to go deep. Pretty good ball, and it's in and out of the hands. He had a receiver. Yeah. It was Riant Chowell. That was the best-looking ball we've seen thrown tonight. As we mentioned, Swenson was quarterback a couple seasons ago for the Stockmen and almost connected inside the red zone. But instead, it'll be fourth down and 22. Twelve-and-a-half and rolling to halftime. Speaking of Andrew Mathers, he will join us at halftime. We caught up with him before the game to talk about the Omaha Stockmen program. We'll bring that to you during halftime. Fourth down, 22. Defense looking for a stop. They cross up the high motion in the backfield. Here comes the pass rush. Swenson, no chance. He's going to go down. Sacked inside his own 5-yard line. And the defense dismantled the Stockmen on that drive.
Yeah, it looks, the Beef defensive line moves pretty well. I mean, they aren't super big people. And they're moving fast, and they just.
That was the impression I got, too. Size, it doesn't look like they necessarily have. They do have the mobility and the speed. Going to be curious to see when they see some of those. There's some big offensive lines this season in the CIF. I know up in Sioux City, and Billings will probably have a pretty good one as well. Come Friday night, it's going to be a different level of competition. But for now, it's first and goal for Tommy Armstrong in the Beef offense as we go under 12 minutes to go here in the second quarter. They start at their own 5-yard line, or the Stockmen 5-yard line, first and goal. A little sweep motion. Armstrong keeps it himself, and he gets stacked up. He's going to lose a yard. It'll be second and goal from the 6.
Yeah, pretty basic. That was just like the first play, the offensive play of the game for them. And he gave it that time, but he didn't this time.
You kind of feel like that Stockmen defense might be keying in on Armstrong.
I think so.
Just not going to let him make a play. Anybody who can make a tackle against him, that's going to be kind of a big deal for them here tonight. as he's not had success on the ground so far. Pistol formation for Armstrong. Two wideouts on the far side, one on the near side, two in high motion. Armstrong, good snap, and misread the play, ends up keeping himself. Picks up a yard, looked like he was supposed to hand it off. His running back did not take the ball, and Armstrong tried to make the most of it as he gets back to the 5-yard line, be third and goal. So the opening offensive drive, Omaha started at the 5-yard line of the Stockmen and did not get it in. They had to settle for a field goal. We'll see if this time from the 5-yard line, if they are able to find the end zone. 10-20 and counting, third down and goal. Trips to the far side, two in motion, pistol formation. Armstrong swings it out, and he finds the corner into the end zone. It's a touchdown for Omaha. Singleton gets his second touchdown of the night. Just a little pitch out to the left side. He found that corner and took it in for the score. There is a flag in the backfield.
Well, that was thrown from over there. So they threw one in the end zone also.
We'll get the call. Vernon Brakefield, our referee tonight. Great to see Vernon again.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Always.
As they discuss this play, see what the call is.
Touchdown.
Penalty's personal foul against Cameron Hunt, linebacker for the Beef out of North Dakota. That's his first personal foul to get you ejected. Would not get you suspended, though, for the next game, as this is exhibition play.
Yeah.
So I guess they're free tonight, I think. Unless they've changed that rule, who knows? Don't want to find out, though.
No, we don't know what the fine structure is either.
Well, we do not, no. Fine means it's okay, right?
Yeah.
So here Omaha's going to go for one of these extra point scenarios. They're going to try for the three-point conversion, move it back to the 5-yard line of the CIF bonus round.
Oops.
After missing the last two extra points of Brandon Stewart, Omaha will get a chance as they have elected to go for the three-point conversion from the 5-yard line. Pistol formation, Singleton to the right of Armstrong. Armstrong still trying to direct traffic. Now puts the men into high motion. High snap, Armstrong brings it down. Here comes the pass rush. He looks in the end zone.
Yes.
And it's complete for a three-point conversion. How exciting is that, Kirk Heyer? Jordan,
yeah.
Barton on the three-point conversion reception.
Nice pass, nice catch. Receiver came all the way from the left to the right across the backboards and made the catch.
Timeout on the field because that was so exciting. We'll be right back. 9:05 remaining till halftime. Omaha Beef on top of the Stockmen, 30-0. You're listening to Beef, professional indoor football here on the Boomer Sports Network.
It is expensive to buy a house right now in Omaha. We know, so you're looking to rent. Smart move, but you need to be smart with who you rent with. You need to check out Crown Property Management for your next rental. Professional property management, not just some landlords owning properties as a hobby. They take care of your issues and are fair and honest. AC goes out, they're on it. Roof leaks, just hit them up. Orange slime coming out of your sewer, we know nobody wants to deal with orange stuff. Find your next property at crownmanagementomaha.com. When looking for your next property, just look for the crown.
Whether it's small-scale digital printing projects or a high-volume, high-end offset print project, DBS Burke has the proper equipment and craftsman-level machine operators to produce your message beyond your expectation. Find out why DBS Burke is the best source for mailing services, kitting, and fulfillment wide-format printing projects such as posters, banners, signs, and signage. Call today, 402-455-1200, to schedule your next appointment.
Football fans, are you an ink fan? Well, stop by and see our friends over at Eternal Tattoo and Body Piercing at any of their multiple facilities all across the Omaha and Lincoln metro areas. They are providing the cleanest facilities, which you know is important, especially in these times, and the best quality tattoo and body piercing services around this area. Check them out for yourself. Find a location, visit them online, eternalinc.biz today for more information.
The HVAC guy you called says your system is shot and needs to be replaced. Get a second opinion. Call Titanium HVAC and they'll tell you whether you actually do need a replacement or just a repair. Titanium HVAC, where honesty and quality come standard. Titanium.
This part of your Omaha Beef action is brought to you by the following sponsors: JT Auto Body, Inland Sprinkler Services, BNC Framing, Countertops by Design, and Carlson Kennedy Construction. Thanks for being a part of the Omaha Beat.
From the Stockmen, 30-0. Boy, eternal tattoos.
Let's give it up for some amazing sponsors of your Omaha Beat, including Legend Pool and Spa, Omaha Marine Center, Comfort Inn and Suites, Stay Sharp, and Lou's Sporting Goods. Thanks to all of our great partners with the Omaha Beat.
Outlaws, first time in their reincarnation. So the first time they will visit Ralston will be on Friday night. Note that is a 7:05 kickoff to the weeknight game. Stewart puts the ball into play. It is fielded at the 2-yard line, brought out 5-10. Oh, nice tackle in the open field. Travion Samuel out of Memphis. Nice tackle, and those are the little things that you're looking for in the preseason. Guys that make tackles like that on special teams, those are the things that make teams.
Well, it is, and that's the first time, really, that Brandon got the ball up in the air on the kickoff. Everything he's been had line drives before. I don't know if by design or whatever, but that one did go in the air, and it got some good coverage. Oh, personal foul.
Well, the personal foul is from the extra point. It was in the bank. They'll add that to the end of that return, so he did not have much, but they'll give him 15, which puts it to the Beef 24-yard line. So since if you're new to indoor, you can't kick it off from the zero, the goal line, you can't back it up before the kick. They mark it afterwards and put the 15 on the end of the run, and the Stockmen will start at the Beef 24-yard line, trailing by 30, 8:40 and counting here till halftime. They go back to Taylor at quarterback. He goes on the keeper. Nice little run inside the 20. He gets stacked up, but it took four Beef players to bring him down as he gains 5 yards and one of the most positive plays offensively for the Stockmen here in the first half.
Yeah, they had some of their offensive linemen kind of out in front of them to build a wall. Those guys are good-sized people.
Second down and 5. Stockmen looking for their first down of the night. They need to get to the 14-yard line. High snap, empty formation. Taylor, complete near the 15-yard line. Let's see where they spot it. We're going to mark him just a yard short. It'll be third down and 1 as they put the ball at the 15. So all of a sudden, we see a couple good, positive plays as they go back to the original quarterback of the night, Shaka Taylor. Maybe settle them down a little bit as they put Swenson in for a couple of plays. And the Stockmen would like to get a little success by getting their first down. They're 1 yard away from doing it. Halfway through the second quarter, they stack the far side. Two wideouts high will come into motion. High snap brings it down. The ball's on the turf, and Omaha has it. A promising Stockmen drive ends on a bad snap that was high. And the Stockmen could not bring down. Deshaun Benton came in out of East Carolina and jumped on the ball for the defense, forcing another turnover with 7-1 remaining here in the second quarter. So the Beef will have good field position at their own 22-yard line. And I thought they signaled for a media timeout. But now they're going to review. We
got a review. Do you know what they're reviewing, Kirk?
No, I don't. Well, there was a little bit of extracurricular activity. I don't know if that's what they're looking at.
So we have our first review of the night. I don't think it was on the turnover. That looked pretty straightforward.
Oh, yeah.
It was a high snap that was never covered. I suppose I didn't see any motion if they were looking to see if someone was offsides. Let's see on the board here if we can see what they're looking at. Oh, they're going to show us the officials. But you wanted it, Kirk. A replay.
Yes.
It's 30-0 with 7:01 remaining here till halftime. And whatever it is they're reviewing did not take long. The headphones are back off. And we'll let Vernon Brakefield explain to us what is happening. I guess it was not that straightforward. They were going to say that was a forward pass. They said he had control and threw that forward. I just saw the replay. Watch the board, Kirk. I don't know.
It looked like it was like a two-handed chest.
It looked like a volleyball set.
Yeah.
Like the ball was there and he kind of, you know, pushed it forward. I guess that's a forward pass. So good news for the Stockmen. Maybe they're just trying to keep the Stockmen on offense, which is fine. It's probably for the best as well, but after the review, it'll be fourth down and one. Stockmen will have another shot at moving the chains. Taylor out of the pistol formation. KJ Johnson lines up with him. Two wideouts near side, one on the far side. We have official stoppage once again. We try to make sure the down markers are now in the right place. It's preseason. Not that that would make any difference. I mean, we've seen this in the regular season too, but you get an excuse tonight though.
That's right.
All right. Everything's where we need it. We're ready to go with this fourth down and one. Taylor. Wants a timeout. After all of that, the play clock was running out, and the Stockmen will take their first timeout with 6:53 remaining until halftime. Take a quick timeout. Be right back. You're listening to Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football right here on the Boomer Sports Network. Make a statement with Evans Custom Apparel, your go-to destination for all your custom apparel needs and online stores. Proudly family-owned and operated, we offer top-notch screen printing, embroidery, and promotional products. Whether you're in the office or on the field, make the change and discover the Evans difference today. The Pit Barbecue Lounge on 72nd and Highway 370, the official barbecue of the Omaha Beef. Back at the slaughterhouse. Timeout is completed. Interesting, Stockmen had a water boy out there who looked a lot like Greg Hendricks.
Yes, he did.
And the Beef did not have water out there, which is interesting. It's preseason.
Taylor, on the quarterback keeper, they try to
stack and push him, and there's nothing doing as the defensive line pushed back and stopped. The Stockmen on fourth down. You kind of like the play call because they have not run that yet, but they probably telegraphed it because they put him under center.
Yeah.
And you got the mismatches. We've talked about it all night athletically between the two lines, and once you telegraph that, it was kind of an easy stop for Omaha.
Yeah.
I thought they might do something else out of that instead of that sneak, but They did not, and Omaha takes over with 6:35 remaining till halftime. They lead 30-0. As Tommy Armstrong leads the offense back on the field, and despite the score being lopsided, we have not seen a whole lot of offense from the Beef here in the first half, or at least not a lot of good offense. A couple short touchdowns, and that's it. Armstrong throws it, batted up in the air, and it's incomplete. Alex Williams penetrated that offensive line and got in Tommy Armstrong's face and knocked it out of the air. And that's a little concerning. That's a couple times we've seen the Stockmen come right between the tackles and get to the quarterback.
Yeah, nothing stopped them, that's for sure.
Alex Williams out of Midlands. Went right up the middle, broke that play up. Second down and 10, 5.5 to go. Pistol formation, 2 to the near, 1 to the far. 2 on the near side, line up high. They go into motion. Armstrong has it. Screen set up, complete to the 20, out to the 23-yard line, into the boards, complete to Dresante Dorton out of Eastern Washington. Woo, Eastern Washington, beautiful. Jeannie Washington, former
Redfield.
Home. Well, it wasn't back in my day. Former home to Seattle Seahawks training camp.
Yep.
Spent 6 summers out there. As they pick up 7 yards on the play, it'll be 3rd down and 3. Same formation for the Beef. Outside's high motion. Armstrong brings it down, wants to throw. It
nice.
Is complete into Stockmen territory. Nice catch for Omaha as they move the chains as Travion Samuel, 5'8", 175 pounds out of Memphis, with the first down reception. It's to the Stockmen 18-yard line, 4.5 to go. Omaha sends the play in. They break the huddle. Armstrong, pistol formation, 2 to the far side, 1 to the near. Far side in high motion. Armstrong wants to go left. He does, to the boards. It's complete, and now we're starting to see a little bit of rhythm for the first time tonight from Armstrong as it's complete down to the 11-yard line. Good for 7 yards.
Pretty much the same play.
Pretty much the same play, but I don't want to say you had to build confidence, but you do have to build rhythm. We said earlier, you know, he just joined the team on Tuesday, hasn't had a chance to run a lot of that playbook, and that's why he's still out there right now. He may be in for some of the second half as well. Had not got a lot of snaps on offense here in this first half. Second down. High snap, brings it down, hands it off up the middle to the 5, to the goal line. It's a touchdown for Omaha. Alex. Correction, the jersey was tucked under.
35.
Andre Flakes out of Troy University gets his first touchdown of the night. 36-0 for the Beef. They send Brandon Stewart back out after converting the 3-point conversion. I guess we're just going for the extra point this time. 1-for-3 on the night on extra point attempts for the veteran indoor kicker. Good snap, placement's down, kick is up, and it is good, just inside that left upright. And with 3:07 remaining here in the first half of play, the Beef in command, 37-0. So, Kirk, best offensive drive, obviously, of the night.
This pause in the action of your Omaha Beef allows us to thank our great partners, including R Mechanical, Remax Results, Wayne State, Arc Independent Roofing, and All American Insurance. Thanks for being a part of the Omaha Beef.
Familiarity with these receivers, which, again, hasn't spent a lot of time with yet.
Let's give a big shout out to some awesome partners of your Omaha Beef, including Midwest Title Company, Evans Custom Apparel, The Bullet Hole,
defense
Mike Jansen, Custom Decks,
right back
and Complete
it.
Fitness. If you'd like to get your business featured at the next Omaha Beef home game, give us a call at 402-346-BEEF.
Coming up at halftime, we chat with Stockmen head coach.
Did you guys catch all the amazing sponsors we have this year with your Omaha Beef? We want to give another shout out to Midwest Quality Insulation, Sunbelt Rentals, Nebraska Family Chiropractic, Innovative Outdoors, and Nexterior Construction. Thanks for being a part of the Omaha Beef family.
Regular season here tonight. Omaha and Billings will open up their regular seasons Friday night here in Ralston. Stewart approaches the ball. Little squib kick. It bounces around and it goes over the wall at about the 14-yard line. And that's where the Stockmen will start. If you don't follow the sport a lot, if you have the ball on the turf and put it over a wall, it's dead at that
point, yeah.
Location. So they mark it at the 16. So there's no return. An ideal kick is if you could kick it down, get over the wall, or into the wall even.
Into the wall
into
at the
wall,
back.
You have to go over on the sides.
Yeah.
Near the 5-yard line, it would be the ideal kick.
Yeah, because that's something we haven't seen done too. Ideally, in the end zone, drop it right on the bottom of the wall if you could. But
another
really
option, try to get that non-return out of the end zone. If you can stop them in there, it's a rouge for 1 point. 2.5 to go for the Stockmen, trying to find the scoreboard, trying to find a first down. They've been held without either here in the first half. Taylor has pressure, gets out of it. Little run to the 20, lowers the shoulder, and picks up 8 yards. Impressive, actually, as he took on Draco Statham one-on-one. He didn't give up on that play. He lowered. He's got a pretty big frame, but
yeah,
he lowered that shoulder and went for that extra yard. Like seeing that competition out of the Stockmen. They came here to play. Again, there's no doubt. It never is in the preseason games. I mean, the level of talent between these two teams is really not comparable.
Right.
But when you see plays like that, you know that there's good things. And some of these players being local could be on the radar later in the season if Omaha
sure.
Beef have some holes to fill. Those players know that and like to leave a little impression on videotape as well. High motion, second down and 3. Nice throw, but it's intercepted to the 5, the 10, the 15, the 20, midfield brought down in Stockmen territory. He'll probably come back on a legal block, but it's intercepted by Omaha. Ponce de Leon. Yeah, that's his name. Shepherd University.
From the Fountain of Youth.
Well, that's your old friend. This guy, not the Fountain of Youth. We'll let the officials figure out the penalties. As Omaha has already backed it up, as they will get the ball with a minute 20 to go. Block in the back. And Omaha will start at their own 10-yard line. So we always talk about one of the things in the preseason is situations live action that you don't get experience. Minute 20 to go. We're going to go under the 1 minute warning here after this next play. Basically your 2 minute offense and offense. We'll see if Omaha can drive the length of the field. But they're going to do it here as they hand it off, and I think we've got a new quarterback in here as Carlos Rogers has come in relief of Tommy Armstrong at North American University. He will finish up the first half. He spent the beginning of this camp with the Salina Liberty, was cut this week and brought into Omaha. We'll see what he can do with 60 seconds to go. It's a 1 minute warning here in Ralston. You're listening to Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football here on the Boomer Sports Network.
The Garage Company has been serving the Omaha, Council Bluffs, and Lincoln area successfully for 19 years, building over 250 garages every year. As a homeowner, you will be in very good hands, beginning with our knowledgeable sales staff and all the way to the finish with our highly trained installers. See what we have to offer and get a free estimate at thegaragecompany.com.
GBR Auto Sales and Service is your go-to provider for all your car care needs. They offer a full top-to-bottom in-house service center that not only takes care of all of your car's maintenance and repairs, but they even go the extra mile of picking up your car and dropping it off on any services, provided to take the hassle and stress off of your hands. Let them be your car's official provider and partner to keeping it on the road for a very long time while protecting your investment. Visit them at gbrautosalesandservice.com or call today at 402-999-8082 to schedule your next worry-free appointment.
Guardian Window Well Covers protects what you love most. Guardian Window Well Covers manufactures and installs heavy-duty polycarbonate window well covers for basement egress windows. If you are wanting to learn more about Guardian Covers features, cover styles, and cost, visit their website at guardiancovers.com or give them a call at 402-557-0811.
The Pit Barbecue Lounge.
We've got another break in the action, so let's thank some of our great sponsors, including Apple Roofing, Danielson Incorporated, Starkey Auto Care, Lou's Sporting Goods, and Anderson Comfort HVAC.
Back at sold out Liberty First Arena here in Ralston. 1 minute to go here in the first half of play. Omaha Beef trying to add to a 37-0 lead going into halftime. Rogers scrambles out to the 20, to 25, up the far sideline, leaps into a defender, but did not get over him, and he escorted him into the wall. But a good effort takes it down to the 13-yard line of the Stockmen. As did Omaha call a timeout? I'm not sure why the clock stopped to move the chains. That's not a rule here. They reset the clock, empty formation. Rogers complete, near side, down to the 5-yard line. DeSante Dorton, again out of Eastern Washington, the Eagles. Makes a second down and 3. And now we have whistles as the Beef will use their first timeout. Both teams have 2 timeouts left, Kirk, and as we mentioned, starting that drive,
we've Carlos got more
Rogers
action down on the field coming your way in just a moment. But first, let's take this moment to thank Firewater Bar and Grill,
well.
All American Insurance, Midwest Title Company, The Bullet Hole, and Mike Jensen Custom Decks. You want to get your business featured with the Beef? Call us at 402-346-BEEF. Let's give a big Beef shout out to some of our awesome partners, including
really
Complete Fitness, Midwest
Rogers
Quality Insulation, Visual
Liberty,
Edge IT, Comfort Inn and Suites,
secure,
and Firewater Bar and Grill.
Position.
Make sure you check out all of this year's sponsors on our website at beeffootball.com.
Here's a snap. Rogers looks at the end zone, plenty of time. Looks, he had a man, and he missed him too low as he tried to find Dorton in the end zone. Third down is short.
Yeah, he had the time.
So traditional timing rules is we're inside 1 minute. Last minute of the first and second half after the 1 minute warning. Clock's supposed to stop on incomplete passes. That's it, pro timing rules. It did stop when they moved the chains, not sure why, a little bit earlier. 21 seconds to go. Pistol formation for Rogers. 2 wideouts, high motion. They fake the handoff. Rogers keeps it, bounces off a defender, tries to find some room, and he is knocked into the board, which should stop the clock because he did go out of bounds.
Timeout.
And there they don't stop it, and Omaha has to use their second timeout. So again, timeout on the field. And
this break in the action is brought to you by Anderson Comfort HVAC, Wayne State,
water down.
Coors, Air Serv, and Omaha Orthopedic Clinic.
No water. Toughen them up.
toughen them up. It's kind of embarrassing, actually.
Well, I learned that way back.
This break in your beef football is brought to you by the following partners: Sunbelt Rentals, Valpak of Omaha, Drew Roofing, Visual Edge IT, and IRC Independent Roofing.
Yep.
But they didn't have heat stroke back then, did they? How many? I mean, you played pro ball back in the 70s. I mean, how many guys just keeled over? It didn't happen.
No.
Or you didn't hear about it, at least.
No.
Back to action, third down. Rodgers takes it, has time, looks to the end zone, has a man in the back of the end zone. It's too short. It's incomplete. So Rodgers goes to the bench. 7 seconds to go in the half. They're going to send the kicking unit out on the field. And Brandon Stewart will get another opportunity for his second field goal of the night. Oh, no, that was fourth down.
Yeah.
They did not have the down marker correct. So, turnover on down. Stockmen will get a play with 7 seconds to go, starting from their own 7-yard line. Stay with us at halftime. We will chat with Stockmen head coach Andrew Mathers. We will check in on the 3 regular season CIF contests that are in progress here tonight. Stockmen break the huddle, they trail 37-0. Have a whistle as the Stockmen will use their second timeout to talk things over. I don't think they liked the play they had called based on the formation that came on the field. Now, you have to be careful here, obviously. You're in the shadow of your own end zone. You're at the 7-yard line, and we've seen a miscue already that an errant snap ended up in a touchdown. For the Beef. That actually is probably more likely than a play going the length of the field, 44 yards for a touchdown. So whatever they call up here, you want to make sure that you do it safely and not give up that defensive score. Taylor in the pistol, puts a man in motion, drops back. He's in his own end zone. Here's the pressure. He gets away from one, throws it down to the end zone, and it's leaped and nearly caught. He was into traffic. He had a man who was off his hands. A pretty good throw, which, again, you know, they haven't had a lot of playing time, and they're 6 weeks out of their season. We're seeing Taylor throw a lot better than we saw him throw in the first quarter.
Yeah.
We have reached halftime here in Ralston in preseason action for the Omaha Beef, and the Beef go to the locker room leading 37-0. We'll talk about the first half and have some other halftime activities when we come back. A lot to talk about, actually, in that first half performance. We'll be right back as halftime here in Ralston. You're listening to Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football here on the Boomer Sports Network.
Home Matters Construction is the most reliable and best remodeling experience in Papillion, La Vista, Bellevue, and Omaha. What are you remodeling? Basement? Bathroom? Kitchen? At Home Matters Construction, they can do it all. Go see for yourself at hmcomaha.com. Ready to start remodeling today? Call Home Matters Construction at 402-661-0910. Their staff is waiting and ready to help you. Home Matters Construction, building better.
Guardian Window Well Covers protects what you love most. Guardian Window Well Covers manufactures and installs heavy-duty polycarbonate window well covers for basement egress windows. If you are wanting to learn more about Guardian Covers features, cover styles, and cost, visit their website at guardiancovers.com or give them a call at 402-557-0811.
2016, IAMS Wealth Management is a service-oriented organization dedicated to supporting independent investment advisors who provide holistic fiduciary services to clients. We operate as the back office support team for dozens of advisors throughout the country that are experienced in financial planning, investments, insurance, and more. With our assistance, they are equipped to focus their time and energy on what's most important, you and your needs. Call 888-255-7670 or visit our website at IAMSWealthManagement.com.
Mike Jansen Custom Decks is one of Omaha's premier deck builders, family-owned and operated since 1988. They design and build custom decks in wood, composite, or PVC in all sizes, shapes, and designs. Whether you're adding a deck to your home or replacing or enlarging an existing deck, Mike Jansen Custom Decks can help you plan and design a new deck to suit your individual needs and the custom extras you may have in mind. Visit JansenDecks.com to learn more. If you're ready for a new, beautiful, customized deck, call Mike Jansen Custom Decks at 402-896-6897.
Even when a big game isn't on, Jersey Sports Bar, Grill, and Kino doubles as a comfortable neighborhood bar with an aural entertainment provided by state-of-the-art Bose sound system with a digital jukebox accessing over a quarter million songs. Jersey Sports Bar, Grill, and Kino offers over 20 local and international beers on tap and dozens more by the bottle. Full liquor and wine selection as well. Live Kino, where you can win up to $50,000 in cash. Leather Kino chairs, darts, video games, and a staff that prides itself on prompt, friendly, indulgent service. It sets them apart from the run-of-the-mill sports bars. See for yourself. 501 Olson Drive in Papillion.
JT Auto Body and Restoration in Omaha is one of the premier auto body shops serving Eastern Nebraska since 2017. JT Auto Body and Restoration provides the finest auto body service around. They're an independently owned auto repair and restoration shop for any make and model vehicle. They work with all insurance companies and are ASC and iCar certified. They believe in supplying the highest level of service in all areas of their expertise and will go the extra mile to provide you with that level of service. At JT Auto Body and Restoration, you work directly with owners Jason and Travis. They're fully insured and provide a lifetime warranty on the repairs on your vehicle for as long as you own the car. Visit online at www.jtautobodyandrestorationomaha.com.
Attention mechanical engineers and current engineering students. Are you a licensed PE or working towards your PE? Do you value teamwork, fast-paced, creative, and challenging work? We have an opportunity for you. Kelly Engineered Equipment is seeking talented and qualified candidates to join our team.
Back at Ralston, halftime, preseason action. Omaha Beef out in front of the Stockmen, 37-0. Three regular season games kick off for six teams tonight in the CIF. Let's check the scoreboard, Kirk. Gillette at the end of three quarters out in front of Southwest Kansas, 30-6. And then the other two a little closer than probably expected. Sioux City in the second quarter, 18-12 over Rapid City. And at halftime, Salina leads Topeka 39-33. 37-0 here preseason. Stockmen and Beef will be right back, and we'll be talking with the head coach of the Omaha Stockmen, Andrew Mathers. We come back, you're listening to Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football here on the Boomer Sports Network.
Your home makeover is just one click away. Timeless Beauty is yours. With premium stone-coated steel roof, all types of siding, and custom color match gutters from Last Time Exteriors. Getting started is as easy as 1, 2, 3. Choose your system, style, and color, get it professionally installed, and enjoy with Last Time Exteriors. Find out more at lasttimeexteriors.com or call 402-330-0911. You will not be disappointed.
Lifestyles Orthotics and Prosthetics have knowledgeable and experienced staff that have been working with orthopedic surgeons, therapists, and patients for over 25 years.
Yeah,
we're a local
practitioner-owned
O&P facility that puts the needs of our patients first. Find the most up-to-date and state-of-the-art technologies for both upper and lower prosthetics at Lifestyles. We provide patients with custom orthotics and shoe inserts created and modified specifically for you in our clinic workshop. Count on the professionals at Lifestyle Orthotics and Prosthetics to get you moving again. Visit lifestylesop.com and see their customizable plans that fit your needs. Ready for a change today? Perfect. Give them a call now at 402-393-2354. Midwest Quality Insulation treats your home as they would theirs. Midwest Quality Insulation works directly with homeowners, builders, and contractors throughout the Omaha metro area. Go to MidwestQualityInsulation.online and take a look at their vast insulation services, including spray foam, open-closed cell spray foam, fiberglass bats, and many more. Ready to insulate now? Give Midwest Quality Insulation a call at 402-871-9832.
Midwest Title Company has worked for you since 2001 and has been committed to providing individuals like you, real estate agents, and lenders with title insurance and closing services to meet their specific needs. Midwest Title Company is fully capable of handling all of your residential, commercial, and farm transactions with the highest level of service possible. Head on over to MidwestTitle.com and take a look at all of their services. Need their help now? Give them a call at 402-493-6200. They will take care of you, just like they've taken care of thousands before you. Do not hesitate. Call now, 402-493-6200.
Are you looking for a new or different career path? Do you want a career where you can make a difference? The Nebraska Maintenance Academy may be just what you're looking for. This training program will get you ready for a career in multifamily property maintenance out in the field in just 8 weeks. No need to spend a fortune on tuition or years in a classroom. The next session will begin on May 16th, so sign up now online at nemaintenanceacademy.org or call 531-333-4796.
Bird-dogging is when someone is focused like a laser to find the problem and fix it. Like the technicians at Titanium HVAC, if there's a problem with your HVAC system, they will find it and fix it. Titanium HVAC, honesty and quality come standard. TitaniumOmaha.com.
Good evening, everybody. Here at halftime of the exhibition game, Omaha Beef, Omaha Stockmen. Before the game, had a chance to hang out with Omaha Stockmen head coach, good friend, former Beef coach, Andrew Mathers. And coach, good to see you here, and talk a little bit about, you know, obviously you come in as a preseason opponent here. It's experience for your guys, first thing to note, and we've talked about it throughout the game. You guys aren't even kicking off your season for another 6 or 7 weeks. Talk about the challenges getting ready and just what you've seen from the limited exposure you've had before this game for your season.
Yeah, I mean, first of all, I appreciate it. It's good to see you. It's been a lot of fun. It's been a great opportunity for our guys to do something new, have the experience here today, being in the arena, things like that. Definitely a challenge, though. Just learning the indoor rules, the motions, the different things, playing with 8 instead of 11. Has been different for us, but we've worked hard the last couple weeks to try to get some of that down and be able to put on a good show hopefully today.
A lot of people don't know, for some reason there used to be more, but semi-pro teams in Omaha. It's outdoor, 11-man for the most part. There's some other versions of it out there, but when you come to it, and you know, we used to come out to more games. We've had some schedule conflicts the last couple of years, but it's actually what always impressed me with your team specifically. You got some guys playing some fundamentally sound football, even if it's not the same level as a professional level, but you got some guys that are playing some good ball.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's something we put a priority on. First of all, we look for guys that are experienced still, and yeah, they may not be at the professional level, but they're still guys that have college experience and things like that. But then that's something we really focus on, and you don't always hear it in minor league sports with practices being mandatory and things like that, but that's something that we've made a priority. So those guys are out there. We're working fundamentals. We have a full coaching staff with them. That's just something that's important to us so we can put on a good product for people to come out to the game.
You know, the other thing I noticed, I think I did PA for you guys maybe 5 or 6 years ago. You have guys still on the roster from those teams. You got some veterans. You got some experience out there. Al German, I see his name on there still. He's a pretty good athlete. Yep. If I remember, he even suited up as quarterback for a little while for you guys. But you got guys that keep coming back and obviously enjoy the game and put on a good show for you guys.
Yeah, I mean, those guys have been a huge part of this foundation. I think we probably got 7 or 8 that have really been here from the beginning. They're part of the championship runs that we've put together, part of the reason we've been so successful. And we're lucky enough to every year add in a couple new guys, some talented guys from some of these area colleges. It's fun to watch these guys grow, though.
Talk specifically, I know this is a challenge, even I was commissioner of the CIF for a while. All these leagues, it is tough to run leagues, right?
Yeah.
It's tough to have teams around, even tougher at your level. You've bounced around leagues and, you know, you've had championship run the last couple seasons. You know, I think it'd be safe to say, like to see a little more competition from some of your your partners. Talk about the process of that and what it takes to try to find those opportunities to join those leagues.
Yeah, I mean, it is a challenge, and I think it's a little bit of ego, too. Like, we had to really come together this past offseason. A lot of teams in the area, the Midwest, and say, hey, we can all be great in our own leagues and dominate and all that stuff, or we can come together and we can be great in one league. And so we've been lucky enough. We've got seven teams coming in this year that should give us competition every single week, and across the league should see some better competition, and we're pretty excited about that.
Well, and let's talk about just the entertainment value, one of the best-kept secrets in Omaha. If you like sports, especially once the weather's nice, I don't like when you guys play the games and the weather's, you know, not so good. But when it gets nice, you get out there, it's an outdoor game, you're outside. Very inexpensive. Talk about tickets, talk about kids' tickets. Concessions are, you know, $12 a drink and all that fun stuff.
No, our whole goal is family-friendly. We want people to come out. We want people to have fun during the summer, get an opportunity to watch these guys play. So tickets are $10 for adults. All kids get in free, 12 and under. We keep our concessions very, very cheap. I don't remember prices off the top of my head, but it's reasonable. So it's a fun night during the summer that you can come out. We kick off 7 p.m. on Saturday nights, starting April 22nd. So,
and maybe just a couple players still out there listening, didn't even know this existed, wants to, you know, maybe strap it up, give it a shot. Who would they contact?
Yeah, I mean, the best thing to do would be to go, honestly, to our Facebook page, the Omaha Stockmen, and reach out that way and shoot us a message, and we'll get in touch with them.
I believe you're looking for game day staff as well, correct?
Absolutely. We can take game day staff, volunteers. You want something to do, be part of something fun, we'll give you something to do.
That's Andrew Mather, head coach again, owner, everything. He's everything for the Omaha Stockmen, good friend of the program. Good luck for the rest of your season, and hopefully we're able to come out and check out a couple games.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Your home makeover is just one click away. Timeless Beauty is yours. With premium stone-coated steel roof, all types of siding, and custom color match gutters from Last Time Exteriors. Getting started is as easy as 1, 2, 3. Choose your system, style, and color, get it professionally installed, and enjoy with Last Time Exteriors. Find out more at lasttimeexteriors.com or call 402-330-0911. You will not be disappointed.
Lifestyles Orthotics and Prosthetics have knowledgeable and experienced staff that have been working with orthopedic surgeons, therapists, and patients for over 25 years. We're a local practitioner-owned O&P facility that puts the needs of our patients first. Find the most up-to-date and state-of-the-art technologies for both upper and lower prosthetics at Lifestyles. We provide patients with custom orthotics and shoe inserts created and modified specifically for you in our clinic workshop. Count on the professionals at Lifestyle Orthotics and Prosthetics to get you moving again. Visit lifestylesop.com and see their customizable plans that fit your needs. Ready for a change today? Perfect. Give them a call now at 402-393-2354.
Midwest Quality Insulation treats your home as they would theirs. Midwest Quality Insulation works directly with homeowners, builders, and contractors throughout the Omaha metro area. Go to MidwestQualityInsulation.online and take a look at their vast insulation services, including spray foam, open-closed cell spray foam, fiberglass bats, and many more. Ready to insulate now? Give Midwest Quality Insulation a call at 402-871-9832.
OCB Plumbing provides complete residential and commercial plumbing services throughout the Omaha and surrounding areas. Go to ocbplumbing.com to see a complete list of services, including 24/7 emergency service, water heaters, drain cleaning, leak repairs, new construction, and much more. You can even go online and chat live with us during normal business hours or submit a request for a quote. Call us at 402-915-2622. OCB Plumbing, finding and solving your plumbing problems at a fair and honest price.
Back in Ralston, Nebraska. Half number two just about to get started as they clean up the field from the halftime festivities. I'm Todd Walkenhorst, there's Kirk Heyer, and let's talk about what we just witnessed there in the first two quarters of exhibition play for the Omaha Beef. The score, you look up there, it's 37-0, you're thinking, great, that sounds good, right? A lot of points, no points, off, everybody's happy.
Right.
That's probably not what's going on in the locker room right now.
Probably not. But, you know, on the offensive side of the ball, it was pretty vanilla, really. You're looking for the quarterback's run-pass option, that type of thing. And
so you think they're sandbagging? shake your head. They can't see that on radio. Yeah, no, you know that, right?
Yeah. Yeah, but the what they're looking, we're pretty basic on the as far as the offense. Second string quarterback came in, did a little. He showed it, so good, very athletic, running the ball and doing some throwing. So it's pretty much what we expected, really. I mean, it's a few cheap shots in there, a little bit chippiness, just trying some things out. I mean, they're really only been in camp, what, 10 days or whatever, and, you know, just kind of learning things, way to go. There wasn't anything real complicated as far as what they were doing.
So is this type of game you have coached indoor, is this type of game valuable for these teams, or a couple series is valuable for them, or how much of this is really helpful in developing what they're going to do going into the regular season?
I think some of that, too, and I think it's really evaluating personnel, too, because there's going to be, come the end or into next week, probably about five or six guys that aren't going to be here anymore. At least giving them a chance to show what they can do in a game situation. That's kind of the thing. I can hear again, preseason game, exhibition game, what it is. Saw some good things, saw some things that probably weren't quite so good.
Just about ready to kick off half number two. Going to sell a couple more, more barbecue. I like the barbecue ad. That just makes me hungry.
Yes, me too.
They didn't have a spread. Did you notice that? The media spread, they non-existent.
None at all.
You think the beef sellout? I was expecting good things. Disappointed. We'll be right back. Half number two is coming right up. You're listening to Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football here on the Boomer Sports Network.
Midwest Title Company has worked for you since 2001 and has been committed to providing individuals like you, real estate agents, and lenders with title insurance and closing services to meet their specific needs. Midwest Title Company is fully capable of handling. Midwest Title Company has worked for you since 2001 and has been committed to providing individuals like you, real estate agents, and lenders with title insurance and closing services to meet their specific needs. Midwest Title Company is fully capable of handling all of your residential, commercial, and farm transactions with the highest level of service possible. Head on over to MidwestTitle.com and take a look at all of their services. Need their help now? Give them a call at 402-493-6200. They will take care of you, just like they've taken care of thousands before you. Do not hesitate. Call now, 402-493-6200.
Okay, Omaha Real Estate is Omaha's prime choice for residential property management. Our passion is to keep our clients' investments professionally managed, clean, and occupied for a low monthly fee. Follow our Okay Omaha Real Estate Facebook page for available properties to rent or visit our website at okomaharealestate.com.
At Quality Fence, their name says it all. They're all about quality. Their highly trained professionals have been serving the eastern Nebraska area from Omaha to Lincoln and all places in between for 30 years. Go to qualityfence.net and check out their vast selection of vinyl, wood, ornamental, and chain link fencing. They won't put anything in your backyard that they wouldn't put in theirs. So give them a call, 402-896-9325.
Trainer offers a full line of in-stock bracing, home health, and rehabilitation products. Whether your pain results from a chronic condition or an acute injury, they're dedicated to improving your quality of life. Their knowledgeable staff will do their best in assisting you in selecting the appropriate product to best fit your needs. In-stock products for orthopedics, sports medicine, rehabilitation, home health, and patient education. Visit See the Trainer. They've got you covered. Visit them.
South O Roofing is the official roofing company of the Omaha Beef with over 20 years of trusted service to the Omaha and Council Bluffs area. We offer an A+ Better Business Bureau rating, warranties that are real, a business built on repeat customers. Call us for a free estimate at 402-612-0791 or visit our website at southoroofing.com. That's South O Roofing Company, the official roofing company of your Omaha Beef.
Dean Snyder Construction has grown to become one of the largest family and employee-owned construction firms in the Midwest. With over 250 employees and with locations in North and Central Iowa and in Omaha, Nebraska, we offer design, build, construction management, and general construction services commercial markets, including food and beverage processing, industrial and pharmaceutical manufacturing, healthcare, and more. Get more information about Dean Snyder Construction on their website at deansnyder.com or call 402-509-4810.
Ready to kick off half number two here at the slaughterhouse. Although I see a staff member out with duct tape on the field, that's never a good sign.
Stick them, you have to stick those down. Boy, we've got a lot of good sponsors this year. I mean, we've got so many on-field logos. There's something every 10 yards, it really looks good, but you gotta get them stuck down.
More duct tape. Half number two, obviously, we got, as we mentioned, we're going from 35 to 25 players. That's key number one. There's a couple guys, they're gonna be on the bubble. They're trying to make an impression right here. We got a couple of guys that we mentioned from the Stockmen. They're also trying to get on video and, you know, be in the radar of these Omaha Beef coaches. There's local player requirements and whatnot in this league, and sometimes you may just be a phone call away from coming up, if you will,
yeah,
to this league and filling a spot. So there's stuff going on, but the main priority, I'm sure, is to keep everybody healthy and try to make the second half go as efficiently as possible.
Right. They say with these players, you know, sometimes you're 24, 25, 26 years old and say, oh, you know, I still like to play. It's in your blood. And most of these guys played in college. They didn't just walk right out of high school and start playing. So
a couple of them did here for the Stockmen.
Yeah.
Which is says a lot playing tonight against that caliber of athlete. But as we mentioned, impressed with what we have seen. Again, the Stockmen, they are back-to-back champions in their outdoor league. So this is not a slappy team, if you will, that's come in here tonight. Very good at their level, very good at the outdoor game, and still 6 weeks away from even kicking off their season, 6 or 7 weeks, end of April. They will start, as we talked to their head coach during halftime. If you get a chance, Ralston High School is the home for the Stockmen. It's, he says, $10 for an adult ticket, bring your kids for free. If you have a lot of kids, that's a good deal.
Yeah.
The more, the better. That's, you're somebody has 3 or 4 kids, you know. Do I have to go is the question. I just send them in,
go,
right?
Go. That's right.
Go. Have fun. See you in 3 hours.
You mean you brought that whole busload,
oh,
huh?
Oh, gosh. Not here. They charged me here. Anyways, half number two, we're ready to go. The Beef with the big lead will get the ball first, and the Stockmen will kick off. Enriquez with the bouncing kick, fielded at the 13, up the field to midfield, off a couple defenders, into Stockman territory, trying to stay on his feet. It's Jordan Barton out of Western Colorado. He's tackled down at the 18-yard line of the Stockman, and that's where the Beef will begin. Tommy Armstrong is done for the night. Oh, nope. I take it back. Look at that, Kirk. They're sending him back out here. So talking to Rayshon Kaiser before the game, he said he wanted him out in the first half, but he wanted him in long enough to get the reps and get some work in and feel good about him. And the impression would be that he'd like to see a little bit more out of him here tonight. So it'll be first down at the 18-yard line. Armstrong puts two in motion to the near side, takes a snap, drops back, quick throw. It's complete to Barton. He's hit immediately, but it will be good for 6 yards down to the 11-yard line. And that was some good patience right there. Quick step, throw, hits his man. Well-designed play.
Yeah, timing had to be right. It was good play.
That's hard to emulate, the timing plays in practice when you're running against air. Second down for the Beef, right to left on your Boomer radio dial here in the second half. Handoff, running back down to the 5, first down, and goal to go for the Beef. Singleton again on the carry. He's had a pretty good night. Two first half touchdowns for the 5'8", 200-pound running back out of North American University. First and goal. The ball is spotted at the 6. Pistol formation. Tommy Armstrong with Singleton in the backfield. High motion, handoff to Singleton, right up the middle, finds the goal line, touchdown Omaha, and Singleton has his third touchdown of the night. So Omaha strikes quick, under 2 minutes, but it was a drive. It was a short one, it was an 18-yard drive, but they were all positive plays. I think that's something that Coach Tatum, the offensive coordinator, really wants to see and did not see a lot of in the first half.
I think they came through and decided to follow a script because most of those two out of those three plays worked extremely well in the first half. They're going to come back and say, hey, we're going to try it again.
And here's the CIF bonus round. They are going to elect to go for the very exciting three-point conversion. Armstrong puts two men in motion near side, loops them around. Look like we had movement. They let it go. Armstrong scrambles around. He wants the three. He's looking at the end zone. Throws into traffic, and it is incomplete.
Yeah.
And the Beef are denied the exciting three-point conversion. It would have made it a 46-0 game. We'll see if that comes back to haunt them.
Yeah.
Your Omaha Beef are proud to announce tonight's sponsors, including Moose Roofing, Don Muckey American Family Insurance, Nebraska Department of Transportation, 72 Table and Tap, and Cabinet Factory Outlets.
2-point conversion, we're good. They decided to put some excitement out there. So 3 points from 5 yards.
Your Omaha Beef want to give a big shout out to tonight's sponsors, including Charlie's on the Lake, Ralston Kino, First Impressions, Home Beach Tan, and Home Matters Construction. Thanks for being a part of the Omaha Beef.
It's actually a little bit easier.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, am I wrong?
Absolutely.
Then four for.
Let's give a big shout out to some of tonight's sponsors for your Omaha Beef, including Tom Manley Floors, Valpak of Omaha, Hot Works, La Vista, and Bellevue, American Rooter Plumbing, and Mata Auto Repair. Thanks for being a part of your Omaha Beef.
You come out ahead.
Yeah.
If you go for four every time, convert it 1 out of 5 times, you come out ahead.
Come out ahead. Yeah.
Then you get to the point of, why do I need a kicker? I told you, this may not be good for kickers, right?
Right.
You know? Now we just go for it on fourth down. We go for the 4-point conversion, 10-point drives, you know? I mean, anybody could just squib it down the field.
Right, and squib it down the
field. And you get the extra roster spot.
Yeah.
And kickers are head cases, as we know, too. I mean, you get rid of that. Speaking of, Brandon Stewart, here we go. Kicks it off. Nice end-over-head kick. Fielded at the goal line. Out to the 5, the 10. Shake and bake. Out to the 15. 14 yards on the return for the Stockmen. That's Tyler Levy on the return. And the Stockmen will start at the 15. So what are your thoughts on that?
Well, you think, too. I mean, you look for the kicker. I think I always thought the best thing is if you could drop that ball right on the backboard. Right, you know,
right,
and don't because it squirrels, it goofs or squirrels around and does some other stuff. It gives you more time for coverage and so on and so forth. So, but we haven't seen that tonight, and I don't know if we will.
I'm not sure that he could get it all the way to the backboard. Right. To be honest with you, high motion, first down for the Stockmen.
Oh.
Fakes the pitch, keeps it himself. Taylor picks up 5 out to the 20-yard line. He's not afraid to take a hit. I like that.
No,
I'd like to see him in the outdoor game. Might check him out this spring.
Was a decent play. It was a decent play call, too. Got him moving left, and he came back the other way.
So back to my rant on the conversions, though. Now, I understand what they're trying to do.
Uh-huh.
Now, if you have done that with kickers, backed them up, you know, say from the, you know, the 10-yard line, the 20-yard line, made it 3 or 4 points, now that's something they're not going to go for unless you need it.
Right.
Makes the kicking game more important as we have a handoff for another couple of yards, be third down. And puts emphasis back on the kicking game and special teams. And it's a low probability. I think you get risk-reward, makes sense of the point value at that point.
But here again, I mean, I don't know what it's going to do. It's with the play.
Well,
call,
I'll tell you right now,
calling.
Sioux City is now up 27-18. Rapid City then somehow scored six, and Sioux City scored nine. So there's a good chance that they scored the touchdown and went for the very exciting three-point conversion up there in Sioux City.
Yeah.
Little high loop pass. It's incomplete as we have a little battling going behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be fourth down for the Stockmen. So, and this will be the last I talk about tonight.
Okay.
We're going to talk about this every week, I guarantee you. The most efficient and high probability, I think, is that three-point conversion every time from 5 yards out.
5 yards out. You just, because statistics.
Well, statistics. I did math.
Yeah, do the math. I mean, you're exactly right.
Either way, you look like a circus, though, right?
Right.
I mean, it's a little goofy. We'll leave it at that. That's it for this week. We'll continue on Friday. Fourth down for the Stockmen. They line up. They need to get 3 yards to continue the drive. They'll load up the near side. Taylor out of the pistol. Puts two in motion. High snap. Brings it down. Keeps it himself. And a towel flies up. And he throws it to a lineman. Was he eligible? No, he was not. And the ball goes on the ground. We have a flag from the backfield. And we had a punch thrown on the near side. That's going to be one flag. I think the other flag is going to be illegal contact as that ball hit an ineligible lineman. And it's Vernon time. We're going to break it all down. Either way, the Beef have held as we're going to have a couple different penalties, I believe.
Obviously, with the second one, the guy that retaliates, the one that gets caught.
And I was watching the pass. I actually missed what happened, so it sounds like you got a better view. Now, what they really should be doing is running the clock during this discussion, as we have 9:16 remaining here in the third quarter. Reminder, after the game, post-game is where, Kirk?
Therapy.
Therapy Bar and Grill. It is on 108th Street.
Yes.
Between 107th and 109th. Between L and Q.
Q. Yes.
The M&OP, so about O Street, I guess. OP right there in the middle.
And
by the gym.
Right.
There's a gym there. You can do it all.
Right by, and some of our nice sponsors are right out there too. Raising Canes is out there. Little King is out there in the neighborhood.
You know all the food places. Okay. So they wave off the illegal contact penalty on the pass. They said the ball was tipped, which made the lineman eligible. That ended the play. To the post-play penalties, they went with the ever-popular offsetting penalties.
Offsetting, unsportsmanlike conduct.
On everybody. Everybody's bad. And Omaha will get the ball when we come back. 9:16 to go, period number three. Beef out in front of the Stockmen, 43-0. You listen to Omaha Beef, professional indoor football all across the Boomer Sports Network.
This part of the action of your Omaha Beef brought to you by Critter Control, Alpha Automotive, EGS Marine and Auto, Waddington Chiropractic, and Big John's Auto Body. Thanks to all of our great sponsors with the Omaha Beef.
Section on the menu with no artificial colors in any of our menu items. For corporate parties, we have two areas available, each seating up to 20 people. For small parties, we have a party pack to go. Party packs are available for delivery or pickup through our website, TO5BollywoodGrill.com. TO5 Bollywood Grill, the food, the taste, the romance.
The hottest investments around right now are in real estate, but once you purchase the rental property, you need to make sure you manage it right. Crown Property Management, they will help. Many property management companies are not proactive when managing your rentals. The end result? More repairs, more fees, more cost to you because of their lack of management. These aren't property managers, they're rent collectors. Crown Property Management will make sure that your dream investments don't become your nightmares. End result, more money in your pocket. Contact us today, crownmanagementomaha.com.
The
HVAC guy you called says your system is shot and needs to be replaced. Get a second opinion. Call Titanium HVAC and they'll tell you whether you actually do need a replacement or just a repair. Titanium HVAC, where honesty and quality come standard. Titanium Omaha.
We'll be back to more action on the field in just a second. But first, let's take a moment to thank some great sponsors for your Omaha Beef, including Last Time Exteriors, Stocks and Bonds, Primerica, Valdez Painting, and Honeyman Rentals.
On the internet. Reminder, Omaha Beef Coaches Show returns Monday night, 6 o'clock for the Comfort Inn and Suites. It's at the Firewater Bar and Grill attached to the front of it. That will be at 6 o'clock. 6 to 7 o'clock, we invite you to join us, and we invite you to listen on our sister station, Bluffs Country 106.5, Hometown Country. That is the new radio home for the Omaha Beef Coaches Show on Monday nights. First down. Armstrong still in there. He throws. It's complete to the 5-yard line. Nice pass by Armstrong as he finds Devonair Conliff out of Notre Dame College. It'll be first down and goal, and we're seeing some more confidence now from Armstrong as he's starting to get some reps. To goal, they spot it at the 4. 8.5 to go in the third quarter. Pistol formation for Armstrong. Men in motion, a little toss sweep. They hand it off, and it's red. And there's a loss, but we're going to have a face mask, and then a punch, and now another punch. And we've got a little rumble going. We got flags on the play. We got a helmet off. It's empty, thank goodness. And we've got another flag, and we got a hat off of official. That counts as a flag. And we got Greg Hendricks breaking up the fight. We know it's going. Good when Greg's out there.
Well, the cooler heads always prevail, don't they?
Well, he's breaking them up. So we'll sort that all out. Keep the clock running. They miss out on that little key, right? So recap, a little toss sweep over the right side. There's a face mask penalty, obvious face mask penalty. He had him stop, but it didn't look intentional. He didn't let go, but intentional, but he retaliated immediately, and that's what set this all off. And they're going to separate the two teams and restore the order. We talked about early on, we didn't know if they were calling a little tight enough very early on when we saw this, and they weren't throwing flags. And now you have a 43-0 exhibition game. This is where things could get a little troublesome, and one of the downsides of playing these preseason exhibition games. As they sort things out, Stockmen getting some water. They're getting water. Beef, no water. No water for Beef. Stockmen, more hydrated tonight. We've got a lot to work out here. We got three actual flags. We got one hat.
Vernon's hat,
sir. I didn't even know that's what his head looked like. You should put it back on. And we still got him jawing over on the sideline, Kirk. If you have ever been to a game here, you know that the benches are actually on the same side. It's the hockey layout, and the benches are right next to each other, divided at midfield with some plexiglass in the middle. So you can actually kind of look around the plexiglass and get a good look at the other side and exchange pleasantries. This is where you usually have a coach. This was always kind of our jobs, you know. You
hold them back.
Well, you put a coach there, right? So you can't get players there. Put some big bodies there and kind of separate things a little bit. As we're still sorting it out. Beef looking to put this one in the books, move on to their regular season opener Friday night, 7:05. Some tickets are still available, but they have been selling them at a much faster pace. You'll want to get those if you would like to come out here. We were sold out tonight. Great crowd for the preseason game. This has taken so long. Apparently, there's like three lines to the chicken dance. I didn't know the song was that long. So we ended up with the face mask penalty against the Stockmen, which they'll mark off. We ended up with two personal fouls that will offset, but they have ejected Reggie Patrick, veteran offensive lineman, number 70 for Omaha.
I don't know.
And that's the discipline we talked about. I mean,
yeah.
If you're going to let a semi-pro team rattle you, it's not going to get any easier going forward. So they sort it all out. Still trying to figure out where to put the ball. It should be a half a distance foul from where that took place. They'll put it. That's not the right place. It's going to be a first down because of the face mask being a personal foul. So the Beef will get a fresh set of downs. And here now they mark off the half the distance. There we go. 5-yard line, first and goal for the Beef.
Still 8 minutes left in the third quarter.
Yeah, you got to run the clock during that. Could be in the fourth quarter. They're final in Dodge City as Gillette moves to 1-0 as they defeat Southwest Kansas 30-12. First and goal, Omaha Beef. Little toss over to the near side. Stockmen are ready. The swarming defense, no gain on the play. Andre Flakes looking for the hole, could not find it, be second and goal. Salina out in front of Topeka, 53-39, that game in the third quarter. And Sioux City, Rapid City at halftime, Bandits in front of Rapid City, 33-24. 43-0 here. Second and goal for the Beef. Armstrong still in the game here midway through the third quarter. Two wideouts, far side. They go in motion. Armstrong drops back
beauty.
And fires a laser to the touchdown for Omaha. First touchdown completion for Tommy Armstrong tonight. And that's what the fans have been waiting to see.
Yeah, he fired that ball right in there. Right against the back wall.
Well-designed play, again, another timing play, a little slant into the back of the end zone. And Armstrong hit him in stride. Nice little quick hitch. As Gorney Sloan out of Davenport University on the touchdown reception makes it 49-0. Brandon Stewart comes in for the extra point. High snap. Placement's down, kick is up, and this one is good. 6:28 remaining here in the third quarter. Beef have hit the 50 mark. It's 50-0. And correct me if I'm wrong, Kirk. I doubt that I am. But the Stockmen have not got a first down this game. Is that correct?
This break in your Omaha Beef action is brought to you by Drew Metzler, State Farm Insurance, Auto Graphics, Truck Now, Gershwin Mortgage, and Artisan Roofing. For more information on how you can become a great partner with the Omaha Beef, call 402-346-BEEF. Let's give another shout out to some of our great sponsors with the Omaha Beef, including Jim Restoration, Elkhorn West Construction, A.C. Nelson, Trish Electric, and Acme Concrete. Thanks again for being a proud partner with the Omaha Beef.
We'll see if Coach James Kerwin actually finds his way back to Ralston.
More action coming your way in just a moment. But first, let's give another shout out to some great sponsors here with the Omaha Beef. Nebraska Family Chiropractic, Innovative Outdoors, J&S Renovation, Patera Landscaping, and Monarch Tires. Thanks again for being a part of the Omaha Beef.
As fans have begun to exit, getting ready for the rest of their weekend. Stewart, low line drive kick. It will bounce. Be fielded on one hop at the 5. Out to the 10. Near side. Big hit. Still on his feet. He's never hit the ground. And we got a flag now on the near side, and now we got fighting in the middle of the field again, because why not? That return by Tyler Levy, he rolled on the player, never hit the turf. The question is, did he hit the wall? But there was no whistle. And based on the placement of the ball, he did not. They let him go out to midfield, where he then got tripped up. Now the trip up, though, is that contact? That's a question. And then on top of it, there's two flags.
It was a pretty decent return. He showed pretty good speed.
No, he did. So, again, we will sort it out as they stop the clock with 6:11 remaining here in the third quarter. Next week at Liberty First Credit Union Arena, Billings comes into town. The week after, Beef hit the road going to Southwest Kansas, Dodge City. Fell tonight to Gillette in their home opener. Southwest Kansas, you may remember, was actually the opening round playoff opponent for the Beef last season. Came up here, gave them a pretty good game, actually. Went four quarters before the Beef were able to get past them and move on to the CIF championship game against Salina. Here's a call.
No harm, no foul.
Well, we got two personal fouls, which again offset. I thought he just said they're going to re-kick. And they are. So that's going to, more importantly for the Stockmen, wipe out a pretty good return. Now the question was, Kirk, were those fouls after the play or during the play? I thought they were after. If they were post the play, they should get the ball where it's at in its offset without a re-kick. If it was during the play, they should re-kick. Officials are discussing it again.
You can't have unsportsmanlike conduct during the play.
You could.
How?
You punch a guy before the whistle.
I guess. Yeah.
And they will re-kick it. And, I'd hate to start criticizing officiating in a preseason game. But I'm pretty sure they're wrong.
Yeah.
We'll find out. We'll find out after the game. Maybe I'm wrong. But explain that to me. It was... after the play.
I think so too. They just maybe they need kickoff coverage practice or something.
That might be it. We'll kick it off once again. Really slowed things down here in the second half.
Oh my goodness, yes.
Tyler Levy back at his own end zone, awaits the kick. Stewart walks it off and ready to go. High end over end kick, fielded at the three. Here we go again, 5-10. Scoots back, cuts back, far side, 15-20. He's got room into beef territory and into the wall. And a flag in the backfield as he returns it to the Omaha 20-yard line. But we're going to get a block infraction on the Stockmen. That's going to bring this one back.
He is a pretty decent kick returner.
Not bad. So a holding on the return will bring that from the Beef 20 all the way back to the Stockman 7-yard line, a huge penalty on the return. So Stockman will start from their own 7-yard line, 5:28 to go here in the third quarter. Again, if you need a drink after this game, Therapy Bar and Grill is the place to be. Post-game party spot of the Omaha Beef. Players and coaches will be there to discuss tonight's happenings. Here we go, first down. High motion. Taylor, pump fake, throws a little sidearm pass. It is incomplete, had pretty good pressure on him. He falls to the ground. It'll be second down at 10. So the Beef will have to cut 10 players after tonight's ball game. Have to do that by Wednesday night, 48 hours before kickoff of your regular season game, which is Friday this week. You can suit up 21 on game day. 4 will be inactive. We have a timeout taken by the Stockmen, 4:18 to go. We will take it with them. We'll be right back. You're listening to Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football here on the Boomer Sports Network.
Universal Trucks is conveniently located in Omaha, just off I-80 at exit 440. At Universal Trucks, they have a great selection of heavy and medium-duty trucks and trailers. If you're interested in their amazing selection, visit online for more information at universaltrks.com or call 402-891-2652.
The HVAC guy you called says your system is shot and needs to be replaced. Get a second opinion. Call Titanium HVAC, and they'll tell you whether you actually do need a replacement or just a repair. Titanium HVAC, where honesty and quality come standard. TitaniumOmaha.com.
The Pit Barbecue Lounge on 72nd and Highway 370. The official barbecue of the Omaha Beef. Barbecue lounge. Sounds awesome.
Yeah.
We have to find out about that. 4:18 to go here, third quarter of play.
It's time for another shout out for some awesome, amazing Omaha Beef partners, including Nebraska Sneakers, Nexterior Construction, Dirt Devil Detailing, Apple Roofing, and Omaha Orthopedic Clinic.
Move on to the regular season next week. Try to make their third straight.
Thanks to all our awesome fans here in support at the slaughterhouse tonight. Let's also give a big shout out to Danielson Incorporated, Hometown Roofing, Cyril Auto Body, Heartland Audio, and Starkey Auto Care. Thanks for being a part of your Omaha Beef.
Second down and 10 for the Stockmen out of the timeout. Taylor lines up, trips to the near side, has a running back lined up with him. They'll fake the pitch to the running back. Here comes the pressure. He's in his own end zone. He needs to get out. He does. And makes a nice little run back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe picks up a yard or two. And this is a scrappy quarterback. We've seen him finally kind of get his legs. He got benched there for one drive at the towards the end of the first half. And I think it settled him down a little bit. We've seen a better performance since he's come back from that. I think they told him just try not to, you know, take the world on your shoulders. It's not that type of game here tonight.
Well, we're in a number 34. He'd be more of a runner anyhow, right?
I would think so, and I don't know if he's necessarily the starting quarterback come opening day either. Third down, Stockmen looking for that first down. 3.5 to go, the clock is running. Thank goodness. Trips far side, pistol formation. Some light motion, fakes the toss once again. Same quarterback keep. Across the 10-yard line, out to the 11. And it's gonna be fourth down. Fourth down and about two to go. See if the Stockmen can move the chains. Again, coaches show Monday night. 6 to 7 o'clock from the Firewater Bar and Grill at the Comfort Inn and Suites on our sister station, Bluffs Country 106.5, Hometown Country. It's good stuff. You like that, Kirk.
Yeah.
High motion out of the slots, fourth down, pump fake. Taylor has a man, and it is complete. And it is a first down for the Stockmen as they finally move the chains with the completion out to the 17-yard line. You can even see on the bench them signaling that first down. They knew, and they wanted to get it. And they've continued to compete, even with the lopsided score here in this exhibition action. Fresh set of downs, under 2 minutes to go, third quarter. Stockmen on the move. Taylor turns the ball, dances around. He has time, tries to direct traffic. That time evaporates. They got him in the backfield now. He bounces around. He's still on his feet. He needs to get rid of that ball. Not like that. They're going to call that a fumble. Nope, now it's a one-arm incomplete pass. Nope, now it's a two-arm incomplete pass. He had, the official on the far side had one arm signaling incomplete while reaching for his beanbag for the fumble.
To mark it, yeah.
On the other hand, a little confusing. Clock approaches 1 minute to go, third quarter. Beef out in front of the Stockmen, 50 to nothing. Second down, 10 to go, 17-yard line for the Stockmen. They flip the formation, trips to the near side. Taylor takes a snap, looks, little throw, nearly intercepted. It is intercepted. It went up in the air and came back down and was intercepted by Ponce de Leon. He lost his helmet on the interception, but the Beef will take over here in the late stages of the second half.
Well, then they had a photo op in the end zone, which is
seconds to go. Beef may get a playoff here before time expires. Armstrong now has left the game, presumably for the night, as Rogers is back in. First pass is off the fingertips and out of play as time expires here on the third quarter. Moving on, last quarter, 15 minutes to go. Then on to the regular season. Beef in control, 50 to nothing. You're listening to Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football here on the Boomer Sports Network.
Dean Snyder Construction has grown to become one of the largest family and employee-owned construction firms in the Midwest. With over 250 employees and with locations in North and Central Iowa and in Omaha, Nebraska, we offer design, build, construction management, and general construction services commercial markets, including food and beverage processing, industrial and pharmaceutical manufacturing, healthcare, and more. Get more information about Dean Snyder Construction on their website at deansnyder.com or call 402-509-4810.
At All American Insurance, our local independent agency is committed to providing a personalized consultation to ensure that we're protecting those things that matter most to our clients. We are licensed and experienced professionals, partnering with industry insurance companies and offering a broad range of insurance products. Visit AAIOmaha.com to see everything we have to offer for insurance or give us a call at 402-932-1500 to get a quote.
State Farm Insurance agent Amanda Spencer is not only a proud sponsor of the Omaha Beef, but also the proud sponsor of the honorary Family of the Game at all Omaha Beef home games that recognizes those who give back to our community. Amanda and her staff serve the entire states of Nebraska and Iowa, so call her today at 402-346-5553 for a free quote on your car, home, renter's, life, or business insurance needs. You can also visit her website at aspencerinsurance.com. State Farm agent Amanda Spencer, proud sponsor of your Omaha Beef.
The Amazing Pizza Machine voted Omaha's best family entertainment center and best place for birthday parties. The Amazing Pizza Machine is the perfect destination for any celebration, from family gatherings, post-proms, corporate events, and birthday parties. With laser tag, thrill rides, go-karts, bowling, arcade games, and an unlimited buffet, the food and fun at Amazing Pizza Machine never ends. That's the Amazing Pizza Machine, proud partners of your Omaha Beef professional indoor football team.
Final 15 to go here in Ralston. Beef out in front of the Stockmen, 50-0. Preseason action. Regular season action in the CIF. Gillette victorious over Southwest Kansas, 30-12. And Salina has taken control against Topeka, 69-39. Big second half for the Liberty. 27-18 at halftime. Last time we got a report out of Sioux City with the Bandits out in front, as majority of the league starting the regular season here tonight. Omaha and Billings will start their season on Friday night here at the Slaughterhouse. Second down and 10 for the Beef to start the fourth quarter from the 18-yard line. Rogers in, two wideouts on the line of scrimmage on the far side, two in high motion on the near side, there they go. Rogers has time, looks to the far side and off the hands of his receiver. It is incomplete. Aaron Jackson, nope. That's actually Travion Samuel, was unable to bring that in.
Well, the clock is running.
Keep going. Third down and 10 for the Beef, and Rogers, he's trying to get some completions. He's had a tough time in his limited playing duty here tonight in finding receptions. He needs to convert here. Third down and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. Hand off to the running back, and there's a big hole up to the 10, the 5, the end zone. It's a touchdown. And Andre Flakes on the carry out of Troy with his first touchdown of the night, as the Beef are now out in front, 56-0.
He did a good job. That was an awfully high snap.
It's a high snap that brought it down on third down and 10. He found the hole and drove it home. 18-yard touchdown carry for Flakes. Yeah, Stewart will come in for the extra point. Snap. Snap is down. The kick is up. And Stewart splits the uprights. 12:48 to go. B 57. Stockmen 0. As they're falling now.
Hey, Beef fans. Even though the game is almost over, there's still plenty of fun to be had at Therapy Bar and Grill, the official after-game party location of your Omaha Beef. Be sure to join the players, coaches, rump roasters, and even the prime dancers at Therapy Bar and Grill and catch up on all of the post-game excitement. We're less than 3 miles away, 5059 South 108th Street. We'll see you there, and go Beef.
Therapy tonight. Firewater on Monday. Back here in Ralston at the arena on Friday. As those teams start to come in, eight teams of the CIF, same eight teams as a year ago. We don't see that too often in these indoor leagues.
No.
But we do have some ownership changes, especially in those Black Hill teams. Billings, Wyoming, and Rapid City had some shaky ownership towards the end of the 2022 season. It's been stabilized, appears for now. Hopefully we'll continue. It looks like they're in a lot better shape. Excited to see what those teams do here this season. Stewart kicks it off, puts it down at the 2. It's brought out to the 10, the 15, the 20. He's got room up the far sideline. Kicker to beat. Runs right by him. Gets brought down at the 7-yard line. And when you talk about this return, there's another flag.
They're going to throw a flag.
Tyler Levy has a big return. Can't say a couple of holds have not helped him, but he seems to find the gaps. And they're going to bring this one back. Ironically, the rest of the crowd that's still here sounds like Stockmen fans.
Yeah.
Based on the reactions to the calls. That penalty, I think, happened away from the play, actually.
Yeah.
Either way, need to keep the clock running. So they'll mark off the penalty, and the Stockmen will start at their own 9-yard line. Field position has not been good for the Stockmen all night long.
Well, right, they just won first down. What happened?
Got their first down of the game on their last series. And now they're being very liberal with the clock rules, which is something that probably should have happened the entire second half. As we're under 10 minutes to go, run this one out. Get everybody out of here healthy. So, defense looked decent tonight for Omaha, based on what they're playing. Omaha started to get their legs in the second half. As you said, pretty vanilla. Didn't see a whole lot tonight. Low snap, first down. Quarterback keeper once again, and the defense was ready. They stop him for a loss of a couple. Because again, they're... getting it on the far side. Discipline is something that's going to be a little interesting here. You never know what a team's character is going to be like. It seems like they've been pretty feisty tonight. And that's something that they're going to have to avoid, because once you get into the league season, you get ejected. That carries over a game.
Absolutely.
We'll need to dip that in the bud before the regular season starts next week. High motion, second down and 12, out of the end zone. Taylor gets hit and brought down. Actually, that's Swenson back in there. Fights out of the end zone, gets back to the line of scrimmage, be third and long. Approaching the 8-minute mark.
Whoa, whoa.
Third down and 12. Swenson operating out of the gun, out of his own end zone. Tries to line up his players. Line up three to the near side. One to the far side. Empty formation for the Stockmen. Men in motion. Out of his end zone. Has the pass. It's intercepted. Intercepted. Nothing but grass. Fake grass between him and the end zone. It's a touchdown for Omaha. Kai James Black with the interception touchdown out of Davenport University. That was just a bad read by the Stockmen. Threw it right to him and had open field between him and the end zone.
Yeah, we sure had, we had a good view of it. Right in front of us.
Right
bingo.
To him.
Yep.
Had a little pressure on the back side as Swenson tried to get rid of it, but makes the errant pass, and the Beef are out in front 63 to nothing. Stewart will come out, get an extra point practice tonight. And now we have a flag. A flag was just dropped right now, Kirk. As a legal defense on the previous play, Kirk, they're going to wave off that interception and touchdown. What happened that a legal defense was called after the extra point? Special teams comes out of the field to try the extra point. At that point, they drop a flag and call a legal defense on the play before.
They must have got buzzed or something.
They might be buzzed.
Yeah.
Wow. That's And Rayshon Kaiser getting introduced to Vernon Brakefield. He's going to get to know him real well, I bet.
Yes.
They're going to be good friends. As far as officiating mechanics go, now they're going to review whatever it was that they called well after the play, and they stop the clock while they're doing all this. Just run the clock, you can do whatever you want, right, Kirk?
Yeah.
You can go look at whatever. There's been some interesting officiating over the years in indoor football in general. But this is a moment. You know, it's either 57 to nothing or 63 to nothing. I don't think anybody really, I'm not sure what the over-under was on this.
Well, I don't either, but maybe they wanted to have some time to give the fans the trophy.
They're reviewing it. They're going to take time out of the field. We'll take one as well. We'll be right back and find out the verdict when we come back. You're listening to Beef Football here on the Boomer Sports Network.
The Bullet Hole is a veteran-owned and operated indoor shooting range. They offer firearm sales and gunsmithing services. Come join them on Mondays and Thursdays for their lead slinger gun drills, where you can perfect your firearm skills and build confidence in your ability to protect your loved ones. Visit them online at thebh.com.
Back to the slaughterhouse. They are still discussing it. I think we've got a verdict. This is exciting, Kirk.
It is. We'll have to make note of the time here.
My goodness, here we go. And they've reversed the call back to the original call. So let's recap what just happened here. There's an interception. It's returned for a touchdown.
Yes.
the teams go out for the extra point. I mean, they go all that time. They line up for the extra point. Official drops a flag then for an illegal defense on the previous play, which seemed late. That's a late call, right? They then go and review and realize there wasn't an illegal defense and give them the touchdown back. Now we'll kick the extra point. Wow. Stewart comes out, tries the extra point, placement's down, the kick is up, and that one is good. Rolling to 6 minutes left here in the game. Beef 64, Stockmen 0. Between that, I promised I wasn't going to complain about officiating, at least in a preseason game. I was going to be better about that this year, but I'm a failure.
Part of your Omaha Beef action is brought to you by the following sponsor, JT Auto Body, Inland Sprinkler Services, BNC Framing, Countertops by Design, and Carlson Kennedy Construction. Thanks for being a part of the Omaha Beef.
Anyways, at least now they're running the clock. We're going down to 5.5.
Let's give it up for some amazing sponsors of your Omaha Beef, including Legend Pool and Spa, Omaha Marine Center,
here.
Comfort Inn and Suites, Stay Sharp,
just a reminder,
and
Lou's
Sporting Goods.
K-I-B-M.
Thanks to all of our great partners with the Omaha Beef.
94.5 FM, 1490 AM, and on myboomerradio.com. Todd Walker, Kirk Heyer, Omaha Beef professional indoor football. The regular season kicks off Friday night. Join us in person. There's some tickets still available. Should be a good one as Billings comes in here. The Billings Outlaws, their first trip to Ralston. Of course, Billings was a longtime IFL team that Omaha used to play when in that league back in the old days at the Civic, where they used to sell out games.
Yes.
Stewart lines it up. He'll put it into play. We got a 64-point game. Here's a high end over end kick. It is fielded at the 2. And it's brought out to the 15. And the intended return man did not bring that out because he was cut off by Antonio Johnson.
Wasn't it Billings had the first and only indoor football championship played outdoors?
Because of the tornado, right?
Tornado.
Yeah. Antonio Johnson cut off the return man and took that ball himself. You may remember Antonio. Antonio just played with the Beef at one point.
Yep.
Antonio Johnson, I think, has played for every indoor, semi-pro, recreational beer league team in a 100-mile radius. Tonight, suited up for the Stockmen. He's been with them for the last 4 or 5 years. He'll sometimes be on two teams at the same time. I mean, it's amazing. 3.5 to go. Stockmen, one more chance. Swenson drops back. Empty formation. He wants to go downfield. That's a nice pass, but it's going to be behind the intended target, which was it was actually Vic Sweeney. Good looking pass down the field. Almost had him. Stockmen will not be practicing regularly for a few more weeks. As we mentioned, their opener, the end of April. They will play through June, and into July is their playoff season. Regular season for the CIF will wrap up in May this year, playoffs into June. 2nd and 10, nice dump off. It's another first down for the Stockmen as they get to the Omaha Beef 24-yard line. So move the chains for the Stockmen. So we're down to 2.5 to go. You know they'd like to, they just somehow find some points.
Points, yeah.
They'd love to do that before they leave. I was going to say leave town, but they're probably not leaving town. 1st and 10 from the Beef 24. Swenson in the pistol. KJ Johnson lines up with him. Drops back, max protection, and throws it, and it's intercepted. It's intercepted by the Beef. Marcus Gray out of Indiana State getting the interception and ending the Stockmen drive. Gray made a pretty good read on that ball. Good coverage. Jumped right in front of that wide receiver. Maybe even a little contact. But the Beef will take over and run this game out. Clock continues to run. We go under 90 seconds. We'll see if they stop it for the one-minute warning. And no, they're going to stop it because they're going to review this play. Kirk, they're going to review this play. If that was really an interception, with a minute 29 left, the score is 64.
This pause in the action of your Omaha Beef allows us to thank our great partners, including R Mechanical, Remax Stockmen Results, Wayne State, Arc Independent Roofing, and All American Insurance.
No water.
Thanks
no
for
water.
Being a part of the Omaha Beef.
Oh, yeah. Stockmen Water Boys helping the Beef.
Let's give a big shout out to some awesome partners of your Omaha Beef, including Midwest Title Company, Evans Custom Apparel, The Bullet Hole, Mike Jansen, Custom Decks,
fairness, I do think,
and Complete
I
Fitness.
I saw
if you'd like to get your business featured at the next Omaha Beef home game, give us a call at 402-346-BEEF.
Wants to see if that ball hit the turf, if they could somehow.
Did you guys catch all the amazing sponsors we have this year with your Omaha Beef? We want to give another shout out to Midwest Quality Insulation, Sun Belt Rentals, Nebraska Family Chiropractic, Innovative Outdoors, and Nexterior Construction. Thanks for being a part of the Omaha Beef family.
Somewhat ragged.
We've got another break in the
now,
action. So let's thank some
like
of our great sponsors, including Apple Roofing, Danielson Incorporated, Starkey Auto Care, Lou's Sporting Goods, and Anderson Comfort HVAC.
Plenty of time to get over to therapy. There'll be plenty of post-game action tonight. Still reviewing.
We've got more action down on the field coming your way in just a moment. But first, let's take this moment to thank Firewater Bar and Grill, All American Insurance, Midwest Title Company, The Bullet Hole.
So the play is confirmed that will end the Stockmen's hopes
of a score
of scoring here tonight, unless something miraculous happens here defensively. Going to run the clock down towards 1 minute. Beef start at their own 21, trying to run this game out. Rodgers in at quarterback, pump fake, wants to go for it all, has a man in the corner of the end zone. It's a touchdown.
Oh, my.
What a catch.
Beauty.
In the end zone. Graysante Dorton. On the catch, he ran that post route up the near sideline, got open, got hit on the fly, went over the wall into the first row of stands.
Beautiful play.
And gets the score. That's a nice pass.
Yeah.
The only thing that was bad about that pass is he didn't have to put him into the first row. He was that open.
Right, he could have brought it a little bit more to the inside, yeah.
Left him in the field of play. It was more spectacular that way, so that's kind of fun. He beat coverage by a good 4 or 5 steps as the Beef have hit the 70-point mark at the one-minute warning. Stewart comes in. One more shot and an extra point. Placement's down. Kick is up.
Boom.
And it is good. 71-0. 60 seconds to go. And I guess the Stockmen make it. Another shot at scoring. That's one way they could do it. Get the ball back. We'll come back. We'll wrap things up. I can't even talk. 1 minute warning here in Ralston. You're listening to Beef Football on the Boomer Sports Network.
The Bullet Hole is a veteran-owned and operated indoor shooting range. They offer firearm sales and gunsmithing services. Come join them on Mondays and Thursdays for their lead slinger gun drills, where you can perfect your firearm skills and build confidence in your ability to protect your loved ones. Visit them online at thebh.com.
Beyond Golf, located at 12040 McDermott Plaza in La Vista, opened its doors in 2009 in an effort to bridge the long seasonal gap to Midwest golfers. In 2012, the first major addition was our kitchen, and we haven't looked back since. Beyond Golf features indoor golf on some of the world's most famous courses. Enjoy a round of golf in a laid-back atmosphere complete with a full bar, gourmet food menu, and big-screen TVs. Book your tee time online or drop in for one of our craft cocktails, craft beer on draft, or delicious food items. Visit our website at www.beyondgolf.com or by calling us at 402-916-4727.
The Pit Barbecue Lounge on 72nd and Highway 370. The official barbecue of the Omaha Beef. 60 seconds to go here in Omaha. And on to the regular season as the Beef will be victorious here tonight. CIF regular season action kicking off this week. Gillette defeats Southwest Kansas 30-12. Salina has gone final against Topeka, victorious 75-45.
Hey, Beef fans. Even though the game is almost over, there's still plenty of fun to be had at Therapy Bar and Grill, the official after-game party location of your Omaha Beef. Be sure to join the players, coaches, rump roasters, and even the prime dancers at Therapy Bar and Grill and catch up on all of the post-game excitement. We're less than 3 miles away at 5059 South 108th Street. We'll see you there, and go Beef.
For a while, until it wasn't. Never seen that before in indoor football, right?
Not at all.
So we'll see what they bring in to town on Friday. Stewart, that leg's got to be worn out. Puts the ball into play, low line drive kick. They want to return this. It's returned on the fly. 5, 10, 15, 25 out near midfield. They'll pile them up. And a pretty good return as they're still pushing and shoving. And you can hear the whistles. A lot of talking going on over there, Kirk. I don't want to be nitpicky about it, but, you know, it's 71-0.
Yeah.
And you see Beef players dancing and talking in front of the Stockmen bench. I mean, it wasn't – I mean, you got through the game. You wanted that, obviously. But by no means, I don't think there needs to be a lot of that tonight. I'll just leave it at that.
No, not at all.
They'll spot at the 21-yard line for the Stockmen. They'll start the clock again, run this game out, and I think everybody is content with that. Not normal timing rules, but that's okay. Everybody's cool. Might be the last play
last
of the game.
Play. Thankfully.
We'll see if Stockman give it one last shot at the end zone. Swings it in, puts the men in motion. Pump fakes, wants to throw, goes for it all into double coverage. It's intercepted. And can they return it? 5, 10, 15, dodges one, spins around the 20. Omaha wants to take it. It's at midfield. It's Aaron Jackson. He wants to score, but he gets brought down after returning it to the Stockmen 21-yard line. Triple zeros are on the clock. Preseason is over. It's on to the regular season. Beef 71, Stockmen 0. We'll be right back. Wrap this one up. You're listening to Omaha Beef Professional Indoor Football here on the Boomer Sports Network.
Guardian Window Well Covers protects what you love most. Guardian Window Well Covers manufactures and installs heavy-duty polycarbonate window well covers for basement egress windows. If you are wanting to learn more about Guardian Covers features, cover styles, and cost, visit their website at guardiancovers.com or give them a call at 402-557-0811.
Home Matters Construction is the most reliable and best remodeling experience in Papillion, La Vista, Bellevue, and Omaha. What are you remodeling? Basement? Bathroom? Kitchen? At Home Matters Construction, they can do it all. Go see for yourself at hmcomaha.com. Ready to start remodeling today? Call Home Matters Construction at 402-661-0910. Their staff is waiting and ready to help you. Home Matters Construction, building better.
Founded in 2016, IAMS Wealth Management is a service-oriented organization dedicated to supporting independent investment advisors who provide holistic fiduciary services to clients. We operate as the back office support team for.
Let's give a big beef shout out to some of our awesome partners, including Complete Fitness, Midwest Quality Insulation, Visual Edge IT, Comfort Inn and Suites, and Firewater Bar and Grill. Make sure you check out all of this year's sponsors on our website at beeffootball.com.
The Garage Company has been serving the Omaha.
This break in the action is brought to you by Anderson Comfort HVAC, Wayne State,
every year.
Coors,
as a homeowner,
Air Serv, and Omaha Orthopedic Clinic.
Sales staff, and all the way to the finish with our highly trained installers. See what we have to offer and get a free estimate at thegaragecompany.com.
This break in your beef football is brought to you by the following partners: Sunbelt Rentals, Valpak of Omaha, Drew Roofing, Visual Edge IT, and IRC Independent Roofing. Your Omaha Beef are proud to announce tonight's sponsor.
Never even heard of that place, Kirk. Have you?
No.
I'm going now, though. Hyde Slides? That sounds awesome. They don't even have a sign. They're inside the Grover Inn. I mean, that's my kind of place right there. We have to try them out. I love the jingle.
Including Moose Roofing, Don Mucky American Family Insurance, Nebraska Department of Transportation, 72 Table and Tap, and Cabinet Factory Outlet.
You know, we saw a couple things. We talked about throughout the game. You know, there's going to be a lot to improve on.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean,
yes.
There's no doubt about that. You know, you got some reps in. That was one thing that they wanted to see here tonight.
Your Omaha Beef want to give a big shout out to tonight's sponsors, including Charlie's
and,
on the Lake, Ralston
healthy.
Kino.
And amazingly, with as scrappy as this game was, I don't think even one player was helped off the field tonight.
No, I don't think anybody got hurt, which is good. And like you said, we did see a few things. Offense pretty vanilla. But here again, Tommy's only been here a couple of days doing some stuff. And we